Good morning, everyone. Today on Fox and Friends First, forget about who you want to win the White House in 2008. How about which candidate you want to share a meal with? Who do you want to take out to dinner? We're going to reveal who's tops when it comes to that date. Plus, we all know talking in class is a no-no. Wait until you hear about the school that's banning chatter during lunch. And one dog's plea for a date with a presidential pup. That and all the day's top stories on this edition of Fox and Friends First.
Howdy. From the heartland, it's Fox and Friends First from New York City.
What the hell
that's
is
our
that?
That's our Southern good morning. Do you know who that is?
No idea.
No. Do you?
No, I don't. But we welcome it because it had a lot of energy, and we're so glad that you joined us for this Friday morning, the end of the work week for at least a lot of people. Right.
That's right. And we've got a busy 3 hours that kicks off right now. Yesterday we told you about the guy down in Pennsylvania who thought he'd won $102,000 with a slot machine. Turns out there was a technical malfunction. The tech guys in the back were just testing something. That guy's mad. He wants his money. He'll be here live. So will the casino. And remember as well, we were talking about this story out in California. A lawmaker is proposing banning spanking, right?
Oh, gosh.
You might wind up with a $1,000 fine or do some time in the big house.
Yeah.
Well, we've got a woman who writes for one of the San Diego newspapers, and she's going to talk to us about how she's ready to just go ahead and pay the fine because she spanks her kids when it's needed.
So a preemptive fine.
Exactly right.
Preemptive pay. Here's $50. I'd like to hit Cindy.
Just a random swat on the butt. Nothing tough. Just, you know, sometimes that's what it takes.
Yeah, because the argument is, how the heck do you enforce that? I mean, how do you enforce spanking? I don't know, but we are going to debate that coming up today on the show. In the meantime, we have the headlines for you this morning. This morning, President Bush meets with the Secretary of Defense and the Joint Chiefs Chairman, along with incoming Iraq Commander Lieutenant General David Petraeus. The Senate's expected to vote to confirm Petraeus in his new position this morning. Later, the President will address House Republicans who are holding that retreat in Maryland. A bomb rips through the Marriott Hotel in Pakistan's capital, killing one and injuring at least five others. Police say it seems the attacker blew himself up in that blast. The Senate approves a plan preventing companies that hire illegal immigrants from receiving government contracts. Anyone caught breaking the rule would be banned for 10 years. Venezuelan President Hugo Chavez threatens to kick out the U.S. ambassador. Chavez accused him of meddling. The ambassador wants U.S. investors to be fairly compensated when Venezuela's phone company is nationalized. I'm sure the ambassador has a few other complaints about Chavez as well, but he's just being nice by listing one at the moment.
Right. Okay. 647 days until Election Day, but first things first, we know the number one topic most likely will be the Iraq war. Where we're at in the war, where our troops are in the war, and whose policy is actually in play. Right now, if you ask the military, if you ask one general in particular, the guy in charge of the 3rd Infantry, it is Major General Rick Lynch.
Mm-hmm.
Stop complaining about the war, he says, and prepare yourself for a conflict for years to come. If you notice, and he has, the families complaining, the families involved in the war, the families sacrificing, the soldiers themselves are not the ones complaining. It's those on the outside.
That's right. It's not the soldiers. It's not their families. Rick Lynch is saying to those out there, come on, stop it. It's not helping any of us, he says. And as Brian says, one other thing, the U.S. public should not expect what he refers to as should not expect the troop surge to bring a quick resolution. And in fact, and you know, they always get into a little bit of trouble when they start talking about numbers, but he says that success could take twice as long as the 4 years that we've already been in there, because historically, to quell an insurgency, according to the expert, takes about 9 years.
You know, this really struck a nerve with me today, because we've been talking about the Iraq war for so long. We've been talking about the people who are for it, who are against it. And yet this advice to me seems so simple this morning, that coming from the mouth of a general, quit complaining if you're not the one who is there. That is such simple, it's such a simple statement. And yet it really hit home with me today, because it is mostly the people who are not there or who have no ties to people there who are complaining about it. You never really see, when you go to any of these army bases or military bases, people complaining about it
because
it's their loved ones over there.
It's a volunteer force. Also, there's some new strategy that heartens many in Iraq. Everyone's focusing on the 21,500 soldiers going over there and Marines going over there, the surge. But there's really much more to the change in policy. For example, our policy on Iran. Because now, for the first time maybe ever, ever. They now have the go-ahead to kill or capture Iranians they find meddling in Iraq.
And they're trying to change the rules of engagement, because so far the rules of engagement have tilted in the insurgents' favor. So what they're doing is, I think before there were something like 7 things they had to go down a checklist before they could actually squeeze the trigger in many cases. Now they're making it much easier for the men and women over there to protect themselves, and it's about time.
There's about 150 Iranian officials, officers, and those training militias. Do you believe that they have an embed program the Iranians have for the militias that want to train under their tutelage and get armed there? They also have 5 captured. Right now, we have held on to 5 different Iranian officials there who are working for the Iranian Revolutionary Guard, one of which is a leader, and we're going to start trumpeting them, say, look, we got this guy, take a look at him. This is proof Iran is in Iraq, making our lives miserable. We have to change the perception that we have inside that country.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, I'm not offering to cook you guys, but because
I'm sure you're a good cook.
I'd love to try. I really would, and some night maybe I'll have the two of you over, and then you'll never stop talking about it. but I do want to know, if you could go to dinner,
right?
Which candidate for 2008 for the presidential race would you like to go to dinner with?
Before you give us the answer.
It depends if Al Sharpton's in or not. Do we know if Al Sharpton has declared?
Is he a good cook?
Well, you know what? I don't necessarily want him to cook, but if I want him over to someone to hang out with, pal around with, who will speak his mind,
right,
Al should be a contender. But if he hasn't declared an exploratory committee, I'm going to consider him out of contention.
Well, I think he's out of contention.
According
to
the experts who've done a poll, the number one candidate, one of the front runners, who you would like to have over would be Hillary Clinton. Then number in the 2 position, it's a tie between John McCain and Senator Barack Obama.
And you know, in 2000 and 2004, they asked that between President Bush and his candidate, his opponent in 2000 was Al Gore, and in 2004 was John Kerry. Everyone wants to have a beer with George Bush. Over those two.
Sure.
It was just a beer or hanging out?
Beer is, I think, synonymous with hanging out.
With hanging out, right.
I actually invited a president of the United States to my house for dinner once.
Reagan.
I invited Reagan
and
over. Well, I just said that where I lived in D.C., his motorcade was always going by, tying up the traffic. And if he was in the neighborhood anyway, around supper time, just phone ahead. Mrs. Ducey would be happy to, you know, defrost something.
Did he
ever
imagine
how nervous you guys would be if that actually happened? Like, What would you cook? Tell us what you could cook.
What could I cook?
No,
it would be Gretchen, something charred.
This guy can boil anything.
That's exactly right.
He can cook.
Boil some noodles,
rice.
Well, and also Ronald Reagan kind of liked you. Am I right? He found you somewhat entertaining.
He would. He watched the segments I did on the NBC station down there.
And
one day he called for a copy of something. Said he wanted to show his.
And you're like, you know what? Excuse me, intern boy. I'll take this delivery.
I did. I took it over to the White House, and then I was just going to drop it at the gate. And they said, you want to go in, just see the building? The next thing you know, I'm standing right there, shaking hands with the president outside the Oval Office.
Cool.
He didn't invite me in because I wasn't wearing a jacket and a tie.
What were you thinking?
I was thinking I was going to drop it off at like the White House loading gate. All right.
Fine.
Okay, it's just a sound effect.
You guys, what's interesting about this poll as well is that people want to have dinner with Hillary Clinton, but who they think is most favorable in their mind is Rudy Giuliani. So apparently, who you want to have dinner with is not necessarily who you like the most.
Right. Rudy's the guy with the highest favorables and the lowest negatives. In the meantime, is this favorable or is this negative? Out at a parochial school, Catholic school called St. Rose of Lima, or Lima School, Warwick, Rhode Island, because they've had 3 choking incidents over the last number of months, they said, you know what? When kids are choking, we can't hear the choking if kids are just going crazy in the halls during the cafeteria hours. So we got a solution. Everybody needs to shut up.
You know what, you guys, when I read this story this morning, I thought to myself, my husband would be saying, that sounds just like you, Gretchen.
Everybody needs to shut up.
But I would take worrying to the nth degree and come up with this kind of a solution because, you know, I don't know if men and women differ on this, but when we leave for work every day, I worry about 10 gazillion things that could happen to my kids during the day. And this sounds
That's
like
normal.
Something. I know, but I even think that this might be taking it a little bit A little bit too far.
How about way too far? I can't hear the kids choking, so shut up. Here's the thing. During the day, they got to be quiet. They got to sit down. They got to march in the halls. They got to stay in line. They go to lunch. They need a chance for interaction. School is as much about socialization as it is about learning from the blackboard. You got to learn how to get along with little Laura and Big Stan.
Everybody knows Big Stan's trouble. Here's my question. What are they serving at this parochial school that everybody's choking on?
Absolutely.
Three choking incidents in the last number of months.
Filet the fish, for goodness sake.
It's not real fish. It's fish food. It's like it's not really cheese. It's cheese food.
You know what?
So what would be the other remedy then if you can't hear the kids?
You don't have to shut up. Just talk softly or perhaps, and get this, maybe a little discipline in the lunchroom.
How about this, a buddy system. If the guy next to you is choking, tell somebody.
That's exactly right.
All right?
Yeah, but we've all learned that people in society, unfortunately, don't jump to
it. But these are kids.
Big Stan is choking. Let's help him out.
Right. Unless, of course, he's a bully.
This is what's going on in the Doppler. We have a little bit of lake effect snow, as you can see, out in portions of Michigan at this hour. Some moving through West Virginia. Little off to sea overnight. But the big story is, baby, it's cold outside. Particularly throughout the Northeast. Meanwhile, moving out west and down south, little rain through El Paso. Otherwise, for the most part, the United States of America is nice and dry, but bitterly cold right now here in the New York City area. With the wind chill, it feels like it's about 20 below. I'm not making that up. Eventually, here in New York City and Cleveland, we'll go for highs in the mid-20s. Cleveland's going to wind up with probably a little lake effect snow. Down south, mid-Atlantic, they're winding up with 50s and 60s and a lot of sunshine down there. Beautiful day in Orlando and Miami and Tampa as well. Across much of Texas today, temperatures in the 50s, approaching 60 up north in the northern plains. 20s and 30s will be the rule, and Fargo in North Dakota is going to wind up with a little bit of snow late in the day. So really, the chilliest spot for the most part is the Northeast. And after so many people have been talking about, we're not going to get winter, it's here, baby. 50s, as you can see, in the northern Pacific. Almost 70 in Los Angeles and 43 and sunshiny in Denver. Meanwhile, got a live picture, Cleveland snow belt got hit with heavy lake effect snow as the area continues to deal with bitter cold. All right, this is not live. It is taped from yesterday. More snow showers in the forecast for today, although less than an inch is expected to accumulate. The high will only reach around 29, but it will feel much colder than that because of the wind chill factor. All right, and that guy had the smart shovel. All right, that's a quick look at your Fox Travelcast. Back over to Gretchen and Big Stan.
You said smart shovel?
It's one of those smart shovels with the bend in it.
Bend in the neck. It's supposed to save your lumbar.
Yeah, right? Save your back. Exactly.
Save your lumbar. All right, 12 minutes ahead at the top of the hour.
My wife loves that shovel.
You what? Does she use it?
Who do you think?
That should be you. That is
driveway.
So wrong.
Wait, I'm kidding.
And then 12 minutes ahead to the top of the hour, coming up next. She's got a bad knee, too.
She does.
President Bush heads to Maryland to talk strategy with the Republican House members. They're wrapping up that summit there. We're going to talk to someone who's been right inside those meetings.
Plus, more ethics trouble at GE. The feds have arrested the former treasurer of the company's NBC Universal unit, the movie unit. You're watching Fox News Channel, and we have not been asked to spread them.
I'm going to let you in on a little secret.
Mercury Mariner has been winning over lots and lots of Honda and Toyota owners.
They're moving to Mariner for styling and sophistication the other guys can't touch.
Now we're making it easier for you to make the switch with a no-charge moonroof and no-charge 6-disc CD changer.
It's your turn to discover why. You've got to put Mercury on your list.
Now get Mariner with 0% financing for 60 months, plus a no-charge moonroof and 6-disc CD changer.
I'm Pete. I've had nice bosses, mean bosses, short bosses, tall bosses, she bosses, he bosses, they bosses, serious bosses, nervous bosses, and one kind of funny boss. Now I'm the boss, and my plan is to keep the boss happy.
You do what you love. We'll help you keep your investments on track. Fidelity Retirement Income Advantage. Call 1-800-FIDELITY. Smart move.
Get up at 3:30. I got soccer.
Oh, look at that.
I got it.
Here, honey. Who wants one? Honey, would you like one?
Thank you.
Last one here. And then I'm taking you to Zach's. So we'll do that. And then we'll go to the mall, pick up.
I'll get that for you, little buddy.
There we go. There it is. Where's my bun? Is
that my honey bun?
Did you teach him that?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
When you smile. Award-winning printers and copiers so advanced, they're simple. Kyocera gives you new reasons to smile. Brilliant color. Low cost of ownership. That's the power of people-friendly. Only from Kyocera.
Letters from Iwo Jima has been nominated for 4 Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Original Screenplay, and Best Director, Clint Eastwood, and winner of the Golden Globe Award for Best Picture of the Year. Letters from Iwo Jima, rated R, now playing.
It's the latest Paris Peep Show online, the videos she doesn't want you to see.
So dirty.
But it's not just the famous that have to worry. Your most intimate personal life could be exposed to the world. It's your not-so-private privacy. Bill investigates on the next O'Reilly Factor. It's the video Bill Clinton doesn't want you to see. His outrage over this 9/11 docudrama forced ABC to cut out an entire scene. Now, for the first time on TV, we expose the clip at the center of the controversy. The exclusive video is on Hannity's America.
Yeah, you're looking live at St. Louis, where you can barely see the arch, but believe me, it is there. A lot of people get up there early to watch our show. All those with lights on are tuned to Fox and Friends first, and here's what they're about to see.
All right, Brian. Glad to have all those viewers. President Bush speaking later today to White House, or not to White House, to House Republicans, holding a retreat focusing on political strategy. Tennessee Congresswoman Marsha Blackburn was at the GOP retreat. She joins us now from our D.C. Bureau. Good to see you, Congresswoman.
Good to see you, Gretchen.
All right, so tell us what the secrets were inside, because we know that not all Republicans were necessarily agreeing on the same strategy, but what was the consensus of what the strategy should be?
Well, first points first, Gretchen, and I think you're exactly right. We have a big tent, and our party is a big tent party, and the reason we come forward with great ideas is because we have great discussions, and we allow those ideas to percolate. And I think that as we move forward, you're going to see us return to a lot of those ideas, return to a reform agenda, return to working more on waste, fraud, and abuse, making certain that government is reformed and is efficient and is fulfilling the needs that our
constituents. Well, yeah, the Republicans want to get back into power, and this is an important retreat, I guess, because they got to rebuild and they got to do it quick, because if they're going to do anything in 2008, the president's going to be down there today. John Boehner taking control. So far, what indication do you have that the what kind of role the Republicans will have for the next 2 years as minority power?
Well, I tell you, I think that John Boehner is the leader, is doing a very good job. He has been in the minority. He was there when Newt Gingrich came about with the contract with America, and he's a good man to lead us forward. So is Tom Cole, who is going to head the NRCC and our efforts there. And you're going to see us more focused, Brian. We know that there is a lot of work to do. We know we have to rebuild the trust of the American people, and we know that we need to be certain that they know what they can expect from us. You'll see us do a better job communicating.
And yet Gingrich and Boehner are two completely different kinds of leaders.
Isn't that great? They're different people for different times.
Okay, and that's an interesting point. So why don't you explain that?
Well, I think that it is important to know that Newt Gingrich did such a great job building and pulling together that contract with America and helping us to define what being Reagan Republicans were. And I think as we tweak that and we move forward with the 21st century, looking at science and technologies and innovation and what our economy should be, building on economic strength, right, taking those platforms that we have built and put in place and growing those. John Boehner is a good guy to do
right.
It. We have a good leadership team.
And let's talk about the difference. The president's popping up at 12:10, and he's going to have a conference call through the entire caucus. And I know you, the House Republican is very angry about his immigration proposals.
Yeah.
Is there going to be some direct confrontation?
I don't know. You know, everybody is pretty polite and very respectful of the president. And, you know, you don't have to agree with somebody 100% of the time.
But will they fight him? Will they fight him? Because he's going ahead with it, and it's probably
going to
be first.
See, well, I will say this. I think for myself and for many of us who believe that the first thing you do is go down there, you secure that border, and you do not give any amnesty. And I don't see the House Republicans backing down on that. I think that you'll see people remain steadfast in that.
So it's a question and answer period. What question would you like to ask the president?
Well, there again, my question would be about immigration and being certain that we're going to stay focused on immigration, that we're not going to do anything that will raise any taxes, to be certain that we keep the tax reductions
right.
that we put in place so that they spur the innovation and job growth that we need.
And the deficit continues to go down. Thank you very much.
The deficit does go down. Thank you very much.
Representative Blackburn. Appreciate it. She gets to go on a retreat. We'll be on a retreat soon. The weekend's coming up, but straight ahead.
On Fox and Friends First, someone else loses their job in the fallout from the South Carolina cheerleading scandal. And
Kenzie, the Scottish Terrier, wants a date, and she's not just settling for any pooch in the street. She's aiming for a role on the White House lawn with the first dog. You're watching Fox and Friends First. You're tubing it.
Meet Mark Millar, investor.
I help people manage their pet's health. Make the right decisions early on, and your pet will thrive. It's the same with retirement planning. All actions you take today can impact what happens later.
TD Ameritrade offers tools like Morningstar Instant X-Ray to help ensure that your portfolio is properly balanced. Open an easy IRA today and trade commission-free for 45 days. Independence, it's the spirit that drives America's most successful investors.
Here's how it works. Get the nation's slimmest smartphone for only $99.99. The Cube. With easy access to email and Windows Mobile. It's the stylish way to work. From Verizon Wireless, America's most reliable wireless broadband network. Verizon Wireless, it's the network.
At Joseph A. Bank, take an extra 25% off every clearance price in the store. Wool suits, only $148.50. Dress shirts, sports shirts, and sweaters, $29.99. Plus, an extra bonus, sport coats, $94. That's $395 sport coats. Already clearance priced at $188, an incredible $94. Friday through Monday, only at Joseph A. Bank.
Italian tomato with basil and a garlic soup. Fine, ripened tomatoes, gourmet spices, a restaurant quality taste.
Campbell's a select golden label soup.
A superlativo.
And I'm not even Italian.
Why settle when you can select?
This is a classical design we did in Milan.
Residence in
five Eastern. Prestigious awards. So, what can I do for you?
Design a house around this.
Locked, loaded, and in way too deep. Miami Vice, now on demand.
My house.
Stop it.
He started it.
They put fun in dysfunction.
Oh, how about that?
Order Little Miss Sunshine now. Hit movies without the trip to the video store. On demand with Comcast Digital Cable.
We relied on each other, him on me and me on him. When he died, I had to rely on a funeral home that knew what to do, because I didn't. I needed to know that they had enough experience, enough people, enough compassion. I needed to know that he could rely on me one last time.
At Nelson Funeral Home and Crematory, we will be there to listen, to comfort, to give you more for your money.
This is something on YouTube. Apparently, up in Seattle, Washington, Ben and Shelley Dobbs, their dog, Kenzie, who is, as you can see right there, a Scottish Terrier, has put an appeal on the internet. It appears that Kenzie wants a date with Barney the dog at the White House.
This is so cute. Did you just see what she said? She said, hot dog. All right. So apparently they've been trying to get the attention of the president for this date.
I think he's kind of busy with some other stuff. He's not worried about
a retreat conference call.
He doesn't have a handler for
a dog handler?
Yeah. Like a handler who arranges blind dates for Barney? Because I think that would be a good post. Somebody probably would want that job at the White House.
That real good government job if you can get it.
Yeah, so you could set up like a blind date. They have a lot in common. Kenzie likes soccer. Barney likes soccer.
How do you know?
That's what she says on her website.
Of course.
She'll say
anything to get a date.
Put her on a treadmill. She's athletic.
She's an actress.
And we know Barney must be athletic because the president runs.
There's the soccer.
Yeah, she likes soccer. Barney likes soccer. Sounds like they'd be a perfect match.
And there is there's a sample couple of humans mating. And now we'll see if we see.
What?
No. But
on the right of the screen is Drew Barrymore because the owners got the idea from the documentary My Date with Drew. So they figured. And eventually. Drew Barrymore did go out with that guy in that video. So the owners of the dog up in Washington have theorized, well, if it worked for Drew Barrymore, it'll work for Barney the dog.
Meanwhile, there's a friend of Jeb Bush who says that they've sent the video over to Jeb Bush, and I'm sure he's going to get him to consider it. So that's the best way to get to Barney through the president's brother, who was once governor, is now out of a job.
I think the best idea would be, you know how every holiday season that they put out the Barney Cam video?
Yep.
So maybe somehow next year or even before, let's say they could put out like a spring break video or something like that, and they could video their first date. Don't you think that would
be good? It's too weird for me. You know, people asking for dates for their dog with somebody else's dog that they've never met, I just think that's
I'm still upset
odd.
That they're making pandas procreate. Now all of a sudden we're making presidential pooches. Well, they're not interested.
Are you
not
saying there's some sort of actual dog love connection here?
That's what they're hoping for.
Yeah, puppy love. It might be puppy love. I don't think it has anything to do with the owners wanting to get publicity or anything, do you?
No, what I think it is, I admire the way dogs can quickly size up if someone's right for them. They smell their butts.
Oh, my God.
That's the way they do it. They'll walk around, they'll smell each other's butts, goes, it's clean enough for me.
All right, Brian, the sensor has just clicked in. Time to go.
Okay, fine. You know I'm right.
Coming up, he usually speaks out about illegal immigration. Now, White House hopeful Tom Tancredo wants to abolish black and Hispanic caucuses. Very controversial.
Plus, more scandal at NBC. A top executive is arrested for stealing hundreds of thousands of dollars. This, the second ethics problem for NBC in just a week. Details next. You're watching Fox and Friends First. It's Friday. It's early.
Today's weather is brought to you by Aleve. Share your good news at AleveGoodNews.com.
I'm Tracy Durfee, and this is my story. The arthritis in my hand affects everything I do. Picking up a pen, shifting the car, just living your life would sometimes just hurt. I depend on Aleve. I can get through my everyday without being in pain. I take the Aleve, and I keep going.
Honey, have you seen my Lean Pocket sandwiches?
Lean Pockets?
Lean Pockets!
Lean Pockets!
No, hon.
All that rich, hearty taste and only 7 grams of fat.
You are four of a kind.
Four of a kind? I fold.
The surprising taste of Lean Pockets brand sandwiches.
People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals are known for their outrageous campaigns. But official government records show that PETA itself has killed more than 6 animals every working day since 1998. PETA employees now face felony animal cruelty charges for killing puppies and kittens and throwing many of them in a dumpster. Now you know, PETA kills animals and is using your donations to do it. Find out more at PETAKillsAnimals.com.
Has been canceled due to weather. Our next departure is 6 a.m. tomorrow.
No, hey, lady.
It's time to play Take On Orbits. Today's players have bad weather, must book a hotel before the other 200 passengers. Go.
A quick?
Yes.
Dentmore.
Oh, no vacancy. Orbitz TLC lets you find a hotel right from your phone. Next time, Orbitz and go.
Hometown. Golf free for the rest of your life on all of our executive courses and enjoy free lifetime membership in all 8 of our country clubs, including the Arnold Palmer and Nancy Lopez signature courses. Enjoy the best active years of your life in the Villages. Log on to thevillages.com and order your free lifestyle video tour of the Villages today.
Believe millions of tiny mirrors can put you in a gigantic stadium or on a far-off planet or here, or that so much color will make you think that you are actually there. Who will believe this thing inside? Soon? Everyone. It's amazing. It's the mirrors.
HDTV powered by DLP. See how millions of tiny mirrors make the picture amazing.
Save up to $300 on select HDTVs powered by DLP today at Best Buy.
Well, I guess I just like to say that I really do admire him. I think he's a very smart businessman, and he did what he had to do. I'm just, you know, it's a shame that I didn't get the chance to capture the title of Miss USA so he could really get to know me.
Well, there you've got the now former Miss Nevada talking last night on the Greta program.
Katie Reese?
Yeah, exactly right, talking about Donald Trump, who did not give her the second chance that he gave to Tara Conner, and instead she got canned because of those racy photos that were taken about 3 years before she became Miss Nevada.
All right, so you guys were in favor of Donald Trump giving the current Miss USA a second chance.
I was,
yep.
For activities that happened when she was Miss USA.
Right.
This young girl did things 3 years before she assumed the title.
Well, the photos are just so disgusting.
So do you think she should have been given a second chance?
No.
She was just 19. Here's a sample. Okay, we're not. We're not going to show it, but I was going to go to a piece of the interview. Should we do that?
I guess
I do not think so. Despite what it says in the teleprompter,
right. It was that she said she was intoxicated when she took these photos, and they were relatively racy with other women and things like that.
Right.
Well, she was 19 then, and these friends, what bad friends you have, take pictures of you in a bar. Okay, you shouldn't have been doing it, clearly. But she takes these friends, she becomes Miss Nevada, and then her friends, for a few thousand dollars, sends these pictures off without her knowing.
Please, you wouldn't believe what people will do. Come on, we all know
that. But not friends. I could see strangers or paparazzi who stalk me everywhere, because they just love to get a shot of me doing everyday things.
Yeah, but I can understand how somebody who would think, no one will ever find out that it was me who dumped on my friend, and I can make $5,000. There are a lot of people out there just waiting to do just that.
Yeah, I don't know. I sort of feel like there was a double standard here.
She wants to be an actress. Now she can't because she's not Miss Nevada.
She probably will become an actress now because this did happen.
I'm with Gretchen. Just look at
you think she
Vanessa,
has a chance?
Look at Vanessa Williams. She was Miss America, and then those embarrassing photographs of her turned up. Next thing you know, she's a big star.
Yeah. Well, the only difference there was Vanessa Williams had a really great voice, and I don't know. Miss Nevada may have a talent, but she's in the Miss USA program that doesn't have a talent category, so I'm not sure.
Right. They just say get in a bathing suit and walk around there.
That takes a special talent for
right.
some.
Yeah, you gotta do a lot of sit-ups.
But not quite the singing that Vanessa Williams had.
Right. Exactly right.
But anyway, we'll have to see what happens. I think that she was very mature in when she was talking to Greta because she could have really dumped on Mr. Trump.
Donald Trump says that these pictures are disgusting. There's just no two ways about it. Big difference.
Yeah,
and plus Tara Conner
in rehab while she was Miss USA. So there's a difference there too. It's not like she did these things 3 years before.
She's healed now. She went to rehab.
Well, that's what they say. But this just goes to show you that when there are pictures of bad behavior.
Right.
You just look at Michael Richards and you look at all those other things that have been caught on camera phone, and if there is a picture, it's just hard to refute. Yeah, that's not me.
Yeah, sketches, you can say, hey, well, he messed with them.
Rumors you can get away with, but not the pictures, right?
All right,
so we're going to go to the news headlines for you now. This morning, police have issued an Amber Alert after more than 200 searchers failed to find a missing 3-year-old boy in Montana. The kid's father says he brought the boy out to the car Wednesday night, but when he returned from going inside to get another child, the boy had disappeared. White House hopeful Tom Tancredo is calling for the end of the congressional Black and Hispanic caucuses. The Colorado Republican says race-based groups of lawmakers amount to segregation. The father of the coach at the center of the South Carolina cheerleading scandal steps down from the school board. Jill Moore's dad says he wants to take care of his daughter and avoid any conflict of interest. Nicole Kidman was checked out and released from the hospital after a car crash during the shooting of her latest film. Kidman's stunt car was being towed through downtown LA by a camera rig when it skidded and crashed into a street pole. And those are your headlines this morning for this Friday.
Mm-hmm. What's left to talk about? Perhaps the business of the world?
Not a bad idea. The man who wants to take tourists into space now wants to store stem cells. What? The Times says, I'd imagine that's the New York Times, says Sir Richard Branson will launch a Virgin-branded company offering parents a chance to put the umbilical cord blood of newborns into cold storage. The cells may be used later in life to fight disease and injuries, and scientists say that is a very good thing.
That's going on in Great Britain?
Couldn't we get it hotter in here? Who put on the heat? What's going on, Joel?
Hey, Ford lost nearly $13 billion last year, but executive bonuses could be making a comeback. Sources say the company is considering bringing them back to boost morale. I'm all for this. Among the top 6,000 execs, Ford paid no bonuses for the past 2 years. It's all about inspiration to get people to work.
Yep. Roto-Rooter wants to help with all your plumbing problems, including what to do with your bathroom when you're in there. In a new sweepstakes, the company is offering what they call
what?
Pimped Out John. Among other features, it has a flat screen TV, Xbox, iPod with speakers, and a refrigerator with a keg tap.
Can you tell it's Friday?
Why leave? How did that make the cut?
No wife is going to buy that thing for any husband, I can tell you that.
If she loves him.
Praying for constipation.
Let's talk a little bit
about... Got a lot to do.
A lot to do this morning when it comes to General Electric and their NBC television unit. The former treasurer of NBC, a fellow by the name of Victor Jung, has been arrested, and apparently this guy, he's only in his 30s, and about a year and a half ago, apparently, he started this dummy company called NBCU. Now, keep in mind, there is NBC Universal out there, so that almost looks like a real company. Unfortunately, he would divert assets from GE and NBC right into this thing. Next thing you know, he's paying for airplanes, he's buying summer houses in the Hamptons. He got busted.
Yeah, you know, wouldn't somebody like become suspicious like his wife? Because unless she thought that he suddenly just came into a whole bunch of money, private flights to Miami, Antigua, Turks and Caicos.
Honey, where'd that jet come from?
Yeah, I mean, that might be like one of the first questions you might ask at home. And they enjoyed delicacies like shrimp cocktail along the way. I don't know, this guy sounds like he's in a little bit of trouble. 20 years in prison, potentially a maximum fine of $250,000.
More about Maria Bartiromo and what she did with the
money, honey.
Thank you. That's with her shorter hair, and she evidently it's with Citigroup, who's a major sponsor, and she flew around, bumped some people off a plane, went over to Hong Kong, and it didn't seem right for her to take a ride for free on Citicorp's dime. Now it turns out that she's made a number of speeches for Citigroup, which seem relatively rare, would you say, for a business journalist.
Well, she didn't get paid for them, but here's the thing. Apparently, and this is according to the New York Times, last year, late in the year, Citigroup phoned officials at GE and NBC and said, Maria Bartiromo will never be allowed to take another Citigroup jet ever. Well, later, according to this New York Times report, NBC and GE said, we never got that call. We never heard that. She has taken at least two or no more than two trips on the Citi flight. And the guy who said, Maria, I want you to ride on the jet with me, and he bumped a couple of corporate bankers, Citibank bankers, off the flight, he was fired for his judgment and expenses and the way he was handling Bartiromo, because apparently he also is the guy who decided to put up $5 million to sponsor a show on the Sundance Channel with Maria Bartiromo as the co-host.
Yeah, well, he's since lost his job. I think that, the big news this week is that he was a bigwig at Citicorp. He has now, or Citigroup, he has lost his job, and now NBC is in the middle of this fray, and it's going to be interesting to see how the executives there decide to play this one.
Well, here, look at this. GE says that she did not violate any of the channel's ethical standards. How's that possible?
Yeah. They say
They say that they did pay for some of those flights. They paid the $3,000 or $4,000 that they,
$50,000 flight.
You're right, but they thought that was the fair value market, or whatever you'd say, fair market value for that flight.
If you have a lot of coupons, how's that? She did speak for three times on behalf of a major advertiser in Citigroup, and according to the New York Times story, they say that's highly unusual for a business journalist to do that, and she did that three times last year. I know that if we have to give a speech, we have to run it through four or five people before you could even do that. Mm-hmm. And
we're just too lazy, so we don't.
So we know. There must be nothing worthwhile to say.
Yep, there you go. All right, let's real quickly take a look at what's going on Doppler-wise. Dry predominantly across the United States of America. We did have a little bit of lake effect snow moving through portions of the Great Lakes states. Hey, Toba, can you hit the space bar? Thank you very much. Right there. Toba is the sound man who assists me when my garage door opener does not work. like the last couple of mornings. I think it's just so cold, it's kind of affected the machinery in the weather room. There you go. Taking a look, we're going to have bitterly cold temperatures this morning. As you walk out, if you live in the Northeast, down through the Mid-Atlantic, a lot colder today than yesterday. For instance, here in New York City and Boston and Philly, with the wind chill, it's way below zero. That's what it feels like. Pittsburgh and Pennsylvania today, eventually 25 degrees, and that wintry mix. But from the Mid-Atlantic down south, it'll be nice and sunshiny and dry as well. A lot of sunshine, as you can see, in the northern and central plain states today. Down south, Dallas is going to wind up with almost 60 degrees and some high, thin cloudiness. Same clouds in Des Moines, but Des Moines is going to have a temperature just about 20 degrees short of that. All right, along the west coast today, taking a look, Los Angeles, almost 70, and more sun than clouds, just sunshiny at Wayne Newton's place in Vegas. 63 should be the daytime high. Final stop, it'll be dry in Seattle and 52 degrees. All right, that's a quick look at your Fox Travelcast. Brian Kilmeade, I bet you get some sports.
Yeah, and after this sportscast, I'll give you what's happened in the Australian Open. Okay. You could say one small town is on the 50-yard line when it comes to Super Bowl 41. Remington, Indiana sits halfway between Chicago and Indianapolis, and you're just as likely to see folks dressed in Bears orange and blue as you are in Colts blue and white, including Bears fan Brian Lane, for example, not giving up on a promise. He says Bears safety Chris Harris promised him a ticket to the big game if the Bears made it when the defender was a guest on his cable access show in June. Let's watch.
That'd be nice. If you guys make it to the Super Bowl, I'll sell my Harley to go.
All right, hey, but hey, you won't have to sell it. I'll give you tickets. You won't have to sell it.
I'm going to hold you to it. I got you on tape.
All right, hey, it's on tape.
Yep, it's on tape. Harris says he was just messing around during the interview, and the 10 tickets he has goes directly to his family. The mascot for the minor league Austin Toros gets on the wrong side of the ref. You see, the bull, he got a little too excited when he hung from the rim with less than a second left. His head came off. His team called for a technical. Could have cost them the game. Watch this. Think about it. The Toros suspend him now for 2 games for unnecessarily hanging from the rim with the game still going. So, you know, mascots can mess up like anybody else.
Absolutely.
Maybe Donald Trump should give him a second chance.
Just maybe a little too much time in the phony head.
Yeah, and by the way, I don't want you to focus on bulls. We also got to focus on other varmints.
Absolutely. In particular, let's talk about squirrel. Now, remember, was it during the days when the Beverly Hillbillies used to be on TV and Granny was also always talking about frying up some squirrel? There are some people, apparently in New Jersey, who do eat squirrel. And apparently 2 months ago...
Do they know it?
Yeah, they absolutely know it.
Okay.
2 months ago, they detected a squirrel with a very high lead concentration. So out in Ringwood, New Jersey, which is just about 5 miles from where I live, up in the Ramapo Mountains, there's an Indian group that does eat squirrel, apparently.
Yeah, they hunt and fish just like the old days.
That's right. And apparently the EPA has now advised people who live around Ringwood, New Jersey.
Don't eat the glowing squirrel.
Don't eat squirrel more than twice a week. In other words, 2 times a week, that's fine. Once a week, that's fine. Don't eat squirrel more than twice a week.
Let me tell you something. The problem is you can't just have just one squirrel.
Why?
Because nobody can eat just one.
Once you eat it, it's an acquired taste.
You're going to want it like a family, because if you look at squirrel, there's very little meat on them. Right?
I've never looked at it as an entree.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
You have to trust
people that like squirrel. Look at that. You're going to tell me that that's like a snack.
That's mainly tail. It's over. Sound guy.
And what do you do? Go out in your pacer and hope to run over one? You can't shoot it because it's going to be full of buckshot.
All I can tell you is that growing up, we had so many squirrels that got into our walls in our house, and when they die, if they taste anything like they smell, you don't ever want to have a bite. But the best quote from this story is, "We've known for a long time something was wrong here. We just didn't know what it was." I mean, that's so sad. Okay. They've been eating it for a long time, not knowing what's wrong.
Would they please clean up New Jersey? What is going on? Why do we have these stories?
Steve, yeah,
these things
really
happen everywhere. Apparently, the contamination is from a Ford plant that operated in Mahwah, New Jersey in the 60s and 70s. It's been closed, and now they're cleaning it up, but apparently the squirrel went into the toxic waste dump, ate some stuff, not too good for it, and now we're talking about it. Lay off the squirrel.
All right.
Put down the squirrel.
Just ahead on the show, the good news about the economy that the mainstream media isn't telling you about. That's next.
They're squirrely.
The tail itches my nose. Plus, a slot player thought he won big time, only to be told it was a mistake. One man finding out the house always wins the hard way. But is it the fair way? You're watching Fox News Channel, America's Newsroom.
Forgive me. A decade has passed in silence, for I couldn't shame your melody with my Parkinson's. But soon, my brain will send tiny electronic notes to my fingers and bend them to my will as before. Let the neighbors bang on the walls. I will play fortissimo all night long.
Find the confidence to face any condition at Cleveland Clinic.
Around the globe, critics and audiences alike are applauding the power of Pan's Labyrinth. The best film of the year is being hailed as an outstanding work of art on the same altar of high fantasy as the Lord of the Rings trilogy. The phenomenon that has garnered 4 stars across the nation and appears on over 130 critics' top 10 list has now been nominated for filmmaking's highest achievement with 6 Academy Award nominations. Pan's Labyrinth, rated R, now playing.
If we all washed in cold with Tide cold water, we could save enough energy to light up the homes in 1,000 towns. Save loads of energy with Tide cold water.
I'm gonna have a wonderful party today, Grandpa.
Thank you.
Mm-mm, not yet. Do you miss Macy? Do you miss Ribbon?
Oh, good.
I'll give one to myself.
Well, why do I have to wait?
Grandpa, ladies first.
Oh, I knew that. Why don't we have tea?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
Hey, it's Sleeping Beauty.
I didn't sleep a wink.
I know, we've been waiting for you. Have the chest set already?
He cheats.
Hello, Honest Abe.
Whatever.
We just haven't played for so long.
I know. I just got all this stress at work.
It's cool. It happens to a lot of people.
Really?
Absolutely. More than half of adults report experiencing some kind of insomnia at least a few nights a week.
We just want you back.
Thanks, guys.
When you can't sleep, you can't dream. That's why there's Rosarum, the first and only prescription sleep aid that in clinical studies shows no potential for abuse or dependence. Take it when you need it. Stop when you don't. Your doctor can explain why Rosarum is so different. Don't take Rosarum if you're taking Luvox, fluvoxamine, or have severe liver problems. Avoid taking it with alcohol. Don't drive or operate machinery until you know how you'll react to Rosarum. Rosarum may affect some hormones. Consult your doctor about how this may affect you, or if your insomnia doesn't improve. Take Rosarum right before bed. Side effects may include drowsiness, fatigue, and dizziness.
Just talk to your doctor.
Today.
They're playing the first Grand Slam event in the world of tennis. And by the way, we have confirmation now. The men's final is now set. It'll be Roger Federer against Fernando Gonzalez. He has dominated Tommy Haas 6-1, 6-3, 6-1. And on the female side,
right.
Serena Williams against Maria Sharapova. That is one big name final.
Absolutely. All right, Greg Kelly is the big name in Washington journalism. And he's joining us right now from the Bureau inside because it's too darn cold outside. Right, Greg?
I love that sarcasm. You know I'm a nobody. Good morning. Good to be with you. President Bush, meanwhile, the biggest name in Washington, D.C., he has switched from promoting his domestic initiative from the State of the Union. Yesterday it was health care out in Missouri. The day before he talked about energy in Wilmington. Today, the war on terror, the war in Iraq. The Secretary of Defense, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and the incoming multinational force commander will be meeting with President Bush at the White House this morning, General David Petraeus. He is that incoming commander. Now, behind the scenes, a raging debate continues about the president's plan to send more troops to Iraq. Overwhelmingly, Democrats oppose the president's plan, and there are some key Republicans who oppose it as well. Senator Hagel, Senator John Warner, they're voicing their concerns about this troop surge. And Senator John McCain, well, he is in favor of more troops, and he's trying to broker an agreement, but will not compromise on the troop surge. More from Senator McCain.
We're in flux. We're still discussing what we should do and what. Now, those of us who oppose the resolution, we're trying to, and at least some proposal, as I say, that sets some benchmarks that are specific, might be a way of calming the concerns that many of our colleagues have.
Meanwhile, administration officials are pointing to Prime Minister Maliki's speech yesterday in Iraq, where he vowed to go after terrorist Sunni Shia Kurds, whoever they are. They're seeing that as a very encouraging sign. You talked earlier this morning about how President Bush will be attending the GOP retreat, the congressional retreat out in suburban Maryland. He will be there. We are told that the war on terror, the war in Iraq, will not dominate the proceedings, but they will be mentioned. And we'll see what else we hear, because last year when he did this meeting, he spoke in a microphone for about 10 minutes, and then that microphone was supposed to be turned off, and the reporters were supposed to leave. It was left on, and we heard about 5 minutes of material we weren't supposed to. And who knows, there could be some juicy stuff today. Back to you guys in New York.
All right, we'll be watching. Thank you very much, Greg. We'll see you in an hour.
And by the way, Greg, you'll be here this weekend, right?
Sitting in Steve's chair.
Okay.
All right. Of the very lovely Kieran Chetry.
But whose office are you going to use?
My days of squatting in Steve's, I've decided to retire, give him a break. He needs it. I float around from desk to desk. All I want is a cubby.
You can squat in mine.
Excuse me?
You can squat in my office.
Okay. Thank you very much.
What a wonderful
office. A cubby would
office.
Be nice, too, with a towel, you know, for napping and things like that.
Look at this. We just had an office connection. That's great. Greg, we'll see you in 1 hour. Straight ahead, Hollywood in full swoon over Barack Obama. Could be good news for Hillary Clinton.
Laura Ingraham joins us.
Yep.
Can't wait.
Okay.
We may not all be geniuses, but we can all do something smart. Introducing Hyundai's 199 Sonata Lease. Just 199 a month with only 999 due at signing. It's a smart deal on a really smart car.
Mr. Bloom, you're a homeowner. Thanks. Don't worry about a thing.
Thank you.
Still working on that?
No, I'm done. You know, I was wondering, if we just...
Could have had a V8. 100% vegetable juice. With 3 of your daily vegetable servings in every...
Colonial Honda has one of the largest inventories in its history. With over 450 new Hondas in stock and on the way, there's never been a better time to buy a new Honda at Colonial Honda of Richmond. Now check out these specials.
Get the all-new 2007 Honda Accord, a Consumer Reports Best Buy, for an unbelievable price of just $17,600. But hurry, sale ends February 5th.
Check us out on the web at colonialhondaofrichmond.com. And remember, you take the drive, we'll make it worth your while. Exit 58, I-95.
From the closet to the garage and every space in between. Closet Factory. Professionally designed and locally made. Closet Factory. Custom closets, all shapes and sizes. Closet Factory.
Tired of being disorganized?
Hi, I'm Brian Mueller.
And I'm Teresa Mueller.
Get organized today.
Let our experts custom design a storage solution just for you.
Call today.
It's exciting. It's entertaining. It's a premier company in the cable industry with unique products and services and a wealth of career opportunities. Be empowered to reach your potential with us and see why cable television is an unbeatable opportunity. Brighten up your career with Comcast Spotlight and cable television advertising.
Interested in sales? Find out how you can become a valuable member of Comcast's advertising sales team. For more information on account executives and other available positions, visit us online at www.careers.comcast.com.
Tonight on Out of Bounds. Out of Bounds on Ice with an NHL All-Star wrap-up and much more.
There is worse than the Bruins, and frankly, it has been the Flyers this year.
Out of Bounds tonight at 7 on CNH, the Comcast Network. The action, the matchups, the rivalries. The region's best high school basketball coverage is on CNH Varsity Sports Zone. Saturdays at 3 p.m. on CNH.
Brought to you by Clayton Block Concrete and Sand.
Welcome back, everyone. From doctor to patient, Grey's Anatomy star Isaiah Washington enters rehab. But is it all for show? Joining us from London with all the celebrity gossip is Sky News entertainment correspondent Neil Sean. Good morning to you, Neil.
Morning.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you very much. All right, so, I don't know, another star going for rehab? We don't even know what he's going to rehab for.
Well, you know, over here, I've got to be honest and tell you, we know who the star is and we know who the show is, of course. It's just about starting here. And it could be big, but this sort of situation is going to make him even bigger because we kind of think, what are you going to rehab for? I mean, right. You know, is it like a day at the Holiday Inn or something? You know, what exactly is he going for? He said some words which were obviously slightly controversial, but consequently, I don't really think it's that deep. You know, if he was over here in England, you know, we have people going to rehab over here like they go to the mall or the supermarket. We're not that fussed. So I can't really understand that. The big sort of the big hoo-ha, but it will make him a big star over here, let me tell you.
Well, the big hoo-ha is because he used an anti-gay slur, and one of the other characters on the program, one of the other actors, took exception to it, and it became a big deal, and he repeated the word at the press conference at the Golden Globes. But here's the thing. I thought rehab was for, you know, drugs, alcohol, in some cases sex addiction. What exactly would he be rehabbed from?
I mean, obviously, what he's going to be rehabbed from was making controversial remarks and getting worldwide press, you know. You just have to laugh away. Because it's like, say, somebody saying some comment now, and you think, you dare say to someone, do you want two or three sugars? You'll be in rehab. You know, it's kind of like, be careful what you say. Yeah. And I think the sort of image of all of that, particularly with actors, you've got to be very, very careful. And as I say, I think the guy who's got involved with this and the fighting, etc., the program makers, whichever way they look at it, must be thinking, this is quite good. We've got our program talked about around the world. It's not bad.
But is it not just an escape mechanism for anyone now in Hollywood or anywhere in the public eye? Hey, I don't want to face the press for a couple days, and let's increase publicity. Let's go to rehab. To me, it's kind of a slap in the face to people who actually need rehab.
Well, you're so right. I mean, originally, these sort of places set up, like the Betty Ford Clinic and stuff like that, as really good places for people with serious problems. Now they seem to drop into rehab on the way from changing earrings for a party, you know. I mean, we got a report over here that Lindsay Lohan was allowed out to go to a party. You kind of think, are you in rehab or what? Is this just a break? And it does appear. I mean, you know, you get people like Britney Spears popping in there for a while, and it is a sort of rehabilitation. It doesn't really work, though, because particularly the younger kids just think, oh, what is rehab? Looks a breeze. I'll go.
Yeah, you hate for it to become a joke. Neil Sean, thank you very much for joining us.
A pleasure.
Around tea time, lunchtime, live from London. All right, that wraps up Fox and Friends First. Fox and Friends starts in a couple of minutes, and straight ahead, companies hiring illegals better watch out. New legislation in the Congress could put a hole in your profits.
And the slot machine said, hey, you just won $102,000, but the House says it was all a mistake. A casino controversy that's not going away. We're going to talk to the guy who thought he won, and we're going to talk to the casino. We'll be back.
Kids, we're going to visit the land of our ancestors.
Ireland?
No. Credit card miles expired. Think more distant relatives. This is great! Hey, it's me, Cousin Bob!
Going down.
We gotta switch to Capital One.
Get Capital One's no-hassle rewards with no miles expiration, no earn caps, and no blackout dates.
See, kids? First pass all the way. Something smells good.
AARP is an organization for people who have birthdays. That's because what we do for all. Join us in championing your future and the future of every generation.
Who's in the mood for a big weekend breakfast?
It's Tuesday, Dad.
I know.
No time. Gotta be at school early.
But the stuff's already chopped up. It's Jimmy Dean.
No trip, Dad. Sorry, gotta hustle.
But it's practically ready.
Wish I could. I have a status meeting.
Guys? I have to illuminate the entire Eastern Seaboard in 15 minutes. I think we have time.
The day begins with a happy breakfast. Try new bacon skillets made with real Jimmy Dean bacon.
An artistic approach to family living, where every room has style and form meets function. It's a blending of classic and modern styles to create a beautiful home. For real life, Ethan Allen. Classic design, modern perspective.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thing is, aging doesn't happen one problem at a time. For me, first arthritis hit, then high blood pressure, and the Aleve I took for my arthritis pain, I learned it may interact with my prescriptions. It's a good thing I did my homework.
The pure pain relief of Tylenol Arthritis Pain works all day, and when used as directed, has less drug interaction risk than Aleve.
Absolutely, that's right. Very good.
Travelocity presents The Roaming Gnome, Denouncer of Travel Myths. Our first myth, you never know how long a great deal will last.
Rubbish! Travelocity shows you how many seats are left, so you know when to pounce.
Myth two, American appliances don't work in Europe.
Oh, grow up! Ah! Am I going to die?
Travelocity shows you when there's only a few seats left, so you don't miss out on a great deal. Travelocity, you'll never roam alone.
Good morning, and welcome to Fox and Friends for a Friday. Lawmakers drawing a line in the dirt for companies who hire illegal immigrants. We're going to reveal how folks who break the rules might not be able to cash in on big government bucks. Plus, the latest political power ranking in the 2008 White House race. We're going to reveal who's in the lead, who's in, in the trailing up the rear, and who you would like to have dinner with. And he thought he won $102,000 until the casino said, sorry, tech guy's working on something in the back, all a mistake. We'll hear both sides of the casino controversy, all that in the day's top stories in this Friday edition of Fox and Friends.
Hi, I'm Gloria Stefan, and you're watching Fox and Friends Live.
She was here, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
She did the conga with us, didn't she?
Yeah.
Didn't we do the dance around here?
It was
Everyone
terrific.
Was saying how natural I was doing the conga.
I wasn't going to give my review. But,
who said that?
Yeah, it was really great, Brian.
Actually, no one said that.
Yeah, thank you. That really hurts my feelings.
How about this casino guy? He's going to be here live with us. I wonder how upset he's going to be. Can you imagine winning $100,000 and having somebody come up to you and say, sorry, a technical error? I just can't imagine that.
I got something better than that. When my dad owned a bar, one of his bartenders during the day, the guy said, I don't have a tip. Here's a lotto ticket. They give him the lotto ticket, and he wins $10,000. The guy said, I want half. He goes, I want that back. He goes, no, you're not going to have it back. He ends up going to court and getting sued to get his lotto ticket back. By the time they were done, they made $200 each.
Wow. Plus, we're going to be talking a little later on about a couple of proposed changes. One would be for an air passenger's bill of rights. If you sit out on the tarmac for more than 3 hours, and you know that story about people stuck on the tarmac for 10 hours, something bad would happen to the airline. Also, what exactly is going to happen to that airline that kicked the screaming toddler off? We're going to be talking about that as well.
Oh,
the kid
Brian.
Was screaming for 15 minutes. The parents couldn't get him under control. We
they
know a lot of you
threw the family off.
Yeah, yeah, they gave him 3 round-trip business tickets to any place in the world that they fly.
And I know everybody else has their 3-year-olds are all very well behaved.
They're not. That's not the point.
They can get them in the chair. That's the thing. And just the other thing, we were talking about how the state of New Jersey warning people not to eat more than 2 squirrel per day.
Right.
Brian Kilmeade mentioned a moment ago was talking about how, you know, there's not much meat on them. Oops. Well, Brian, I got an email from Larry in Florida. He said, I'm from Iowa, and I grew up eating squirrel, and 2 squirrels will easily feed a family of 4.
Really?
Wow. That's what Larry said.
Full-grown family of 4?
Well, I don't know exactly how big they are.
You have to be rationed.
Put it this way. Do you know what the Indian said? The Indian said you could tell how hard a winter will be if you see how fat the squirrels are.
That's
because they know because they eat a lot of nuts.
Also, Larry says we also eat raccoon, ducks, pheasants, deer, and beaver. You New Yorkers are so protected, you don't know what you're missing.
You know why?
Thanks, Larry.
Sounds kind of gamey to me. I don't know.
That's what
I think it is game. My thing is you should be forced to eat roadkill as a punishment. You should be more careful.
No, it's damaged goods.
Yeah.
Okay, so should we move
on to the
headlines?
I saw a squirrel get hit. Instead of being in tire tracks, it spun out.
Oh, okay. Well, for all those poor squirrels out there, mate, they're not going to be hunted anymore in New Jersey because you're not supposed to eat them. All right, our headlines for this morning, some big names in the 2008 White House race are heading to the Hawkeye State. Republican Mitt Romney makes his first visit to Iowa today, speaking of Iowa. Democrat John Edwards will be there, too. This weekend, Hillary Clinton is trying to speak directly to voters, attending traditional house party-style conversations with Iowa residents. America needs to, quote, redouble our efforts in the war in Afghanistan. That's what Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice had to say on the matter. The Bush administration plans to ask Congress for $10.8 billion for Afghan security and aid. Interstate 90 reopens near Erie, Pennsylvania after a huge pileup shut it down. Wow. One person died when a sudden whiteout sent 50 vehicles careening into each other. The White House announcing more federal help for Alabama's recovery from Hurricane Katrina. The state will now get at least 90% reimbursement for cleanup and protective measures. And those are your headlines for this Friday morning.
And speaking of Alabama, guess what? Their Senator Jeff Sessions said, you know that minimum wage bill you got going? I have something I'd like to include, and it has a lot to do with illegal immigration.
That's exactly right. And so the Senate did pass it. And in there, there is a proposal by the senator that says, for any company that does business with the federal government, if you have working for you, and he's smiling because it passed, if you have working for you illegal aliens and they don't have proper documentation, you will not be able to get a government contract for 10 years. You will be banned from doing business with Uncle Sam for 10 years. So you better straighten up and fly right.
It's even if you inadvertently are hiring illegal immigrants. I wonder how this will play out, guys, because we've talked a lot about here how illegal immigrants often have driver's licenses that are fake, social security numbers that aren't really theirs. So where will we draw the line there with regard to this bill?
Well, it's pretty simple. There's this program that now 10,000 employers are using. It's called the Basic Pilot Program, and it's used by all these employers to verify whether or not that person is in the country legally. But here's the problem. If the stuff is illegal, if it's stolen, you really can't tell. And so employers are kind of stuck in legal limbo because they might have somebody who's technically in the country illegally, but they got what looks like real stuff.
Yeah. What about illegals that were hired at Fort Bragg? 60 were found to be working at Fort Bragg last July, and 40 illegals were arrested and hired by military contractors in three different states last year. Now, not everyone's pleased about this, including the General Contractors Association. Their representative says this is like using the nuclear option for a paperwork violation, so he thinks it's an overreaction to illegal immigration.
The main thing about these government contracts, I think what they were trying to hone in on here, not just the major problem of illegal immigration and businesses hiring illegal immigrants, it was that they consider it critical to national security, that if you secure a government contract, you do not want any illegal immigrants working within.
That's exactly
because they're thinking about potential terrorism and those sorts of things, having access to secrets. That's the small microcosm of the big problem of illegal immigration.
Also down in Tar Heel, North Carolina, on Tuesday, there apparently ICE showed up, and they have been working with big manufacturer down there, Smithfield Pork Packing Plant. They are a huge giant down there, and they had apparently they did have some complaints from union officials who say, you know what, Smithfield is working with the federal government to discourage us unionizing the plant. And so that's a new one.
All right, let's talk about San Francisco again, and it's not about Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
Well, sort of a little bit, because it's about whether or not every business should be forced to give out sick days to their employees. And whether it's 5 or 9 sick days, of course, that means getting paid when you don't come to work. Now, most big corporations, of course, do offer that to their employees. But a lot of small businesses in San Francisco are saying, look, we can't afford to do this. We're either going to have to raise our prices or not hire as many workers.
So that's what they're going to do, according to San Francisco. It's on the books now. It's an ordinance. And it was approved by the voters out there. People, if you have, let's say you work at a coffee shop, let's say you the coffee cart guy outside our building,
he gets sick days.
No, if he's the employer, he doesn't necessarily get them, but his employees would, up to 9 days. And here's the thing, it's not just if you're sick. In this provision, you can also take the day off to help a sick relative, but if you don't have anybody who's related to you who's sick, you can take a day off to help a sick friend or somebody down the street who you're not related to.
Or someone who has a low-grade fever and needs help moving out that day.
Yeah.
150 for every 30 hours worked, they get an hour. Excuse me. For every 30 hours, you get an hour of sick leave. It turns out that people are going to get an average of 9 sick days a year now.
Yeah. So well, you know they're going to take. You know that most people will take all 9 days. You know, that's been proven that tons of people call in sick when they're not.
I need a mental health day.
Yeah, mental health day. So
have you done that?
No.
Oh,
have you?
It's so embarrassing.
Yes.
Mentally,
you have.
Can't
You've
work.
Taken a mental health day.
Yes, not at Fox. But yes, I have.
Do you
of
label
course.
It? Do you
Come
label
on,
it mental
be,
health?
Let's be truthful.
Do you label it mental health?
No, I just.
At what point do you say I need a mental health day?
When everything just comes together into the same cosmic region and you need to have some time off.
So in other words, when you get tickets to that play or ball game.
Gotta see Lion King.
No, I don't think it's a good idea to go out in public if you're taking one of those mental health days. Just a piece of advice.
8 minutes ahead of the top of the hour. Do you notice that the world is becoming more and more segmented? Okay, do you notice that Washington seems to have factions? Groups,
yes,
caucuses.
They do. And Tom Tancredo, who this weekend up in is going to be traveling this weekend to New Hampshire, does not like the fact that there are black and Hispanic caucuses up in Washington, D.C. on Capitol Hill. And here's one of his quotes. He says, quote, "It is utterly hypocritical for Congress to extol the virtues of a colorblind society while officially sanctioning caucuses that are based solely on race." And so the congressman from Colorado is asking Congress to officially abolish these caucuses, like the black caucus and the Hispanic caucus.
Well, he says it leads to segregation. It's a very controversial point. I don't know if you guys had this experience at college or not, but I remember being in college and there would be certain houses that were segregated based
on
race. Yeah, the Greek houses and different cultural studies houses. And there was always that argument about whether or not it helped to bring the community together because it, you know, heralded the differences in our culture, or if it worked to keep us apart. And I think this is a very interesting point that he's bringing up. It will be extremely controversial.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's bigger on both sides. On the Democratic side, they got 43 in the Black Caucus who are Democrats, and on the Hispanic Caucus, they have 21. But the Hispanic Caucus has associate members where you don't have to be Hispanic, but you're going to be associate member. I guess you sit in the back or over to the side, or I don't know, you don't get to fully participate or bring someone to the Christmas party.
Well, they if they have a Christmas party,
you never know.
If that group has a Christmas
caucuses
party.
Caucuses can party.
There are some who say, why should there be an Hispanic caucus or a black caucus? Can you imagine what hell there would be to pay if there were a white caucus where only white people were allowed to belong? And so anyway, the congressman has made this argument and he's going to be announcing it officially. He has sent the letter and asking Congress to get rid of the caucus.
And he was ripping
Well, he's announced that he's going to run for president too, so he's making some he's making some big statements about what he feels about certain subjects.
A lot of people think that there's not a true conservative in the presidential race on the Republican side. Maybe he's the guy. He also was ripping the president yesterday about his immigration policy. And we know a lot of conservatives are upset that the president seems to be going with his plan and that John McCain and Senator Kennedy also endorse when it comes to immigration. We'll see.
All right.
Where'd Steve go?
Time for the weather.
I'm over here.
Steve, it's really, really cold today. I think today's the first day that at least in the Northeast we're saying, yep, this is winter.
Yeah, you don't really think global warming today. Right now in New York City, we have 9 degrees, and with wind chill, it feels like it is about a dozen degrees below zero. And in fact, it's cold throughout the Northeast. We have a live picture of Boston up in Massachusetts. Right now, it is bitterly cold. It's 3 degrees, but it feels like 15 below with the wind chill today. Oh, there's that Citgo sign everybody always talks about. Why do they have that big Citgo sign down there? They do. Today it's going to be sunny and cloudy with a high temperature in the mid-teens. All right, Citgo, of course, you know, that Chavez thing. Take a look. We got a little lake effect snow moving through portions of Michigan, also through, as you can see, central portions of West Virginia at this hour. We had a little action in the Northeast, but it is out to sea. Down south, things are dry for the most part. A little bit of rain action out in extreme west Texas, out around El Paso. Otherwise, nice dry day across much of the country. Here are your highs for some selected cities, 20s throughout the Northeast, 40s and 50s and 60s from the mid-Atlantic down south. In Orlando today, mid-60s, it's going to be a great day to go see Shamu. Stay out of the tank. Meanwhile, Dallas is going to top out at about 60 degrees. About the same temperature for New Orleans. 30s and 40s across the Central Plains, up in Fargo today, a wintry mix, and 27. Final stop, Southern California, a great day out there. Look at that. Los Angeles, almost 70. It'll be mid-40s in Denver. And that is a quick look at your Fox Travelcast, Gretchen and Brian.
Hey, Steve, he's asking me questions if you take a mental health day, where you can go.
Well, you can't just go out. If you call in sick, you can't go shopping.
You just don't want to get caught. Wherever
exactly.
You go, you don't want to get caught.
You can't, like, start your vacation a day earlier and get found out at the airport.
Right, you can't go to a christening or anything like that.
No.
can't,
He asked me if he could coach soccer.
I go, if I take a sick day, can I coach soccer?
Your team might drop a dime on you.
Absolutely.
Yes, they might take a photo and put it out on YouTube.
That kid who's not playing enough. Coming up straight ahead, why Hollywood may be abandoning Hillary Clinton for Barack Obama. We're talking about a party next week and why that may be a good thing for Senator Hill.
I like to live on the edge.
Edge, the all-new crossover from Ford. The Edge is never dull. This is Jeff.
Check it out.
He likes things automatic. Everything from his wipers to his lights. That's why Jeff has a Fidelity Freedom Fund. It gives him a diversified mix of stocks and bonds. Automatically, of course. Call today to get a Freedom Fund for your IRA. Smart move.
Give a 3:30 hit soccer.
Oh, look at that.
Here, honey. Who wants one? Honey, would you like one?
Thank you.
Last one here. And then I'm taking you to Zach's. Right? So we'll do that. And then we'll go to the mall, pick up. I'll get that for you, little buddy. Here we go. There it is. Okay. Where's my bun? What can make me feel? Is that my honey bun? Did you teach him that?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
When you smile. Award-winning printers and copiers so advanced, they're simple. Kyocera gives you new reasons to smile. Brilliant color. Low cost of ownership. That's the power of people-friendly. Only from Kyocera.
Letters from Iwo Jima has been nominated for 4 Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Original Screenplay, and Best Director Clint Eastwood, and winner of the Golden Globe Award for Best Picture of the Year. Letters from Iwo Jima, rated R, now playing.
They came here illegally, they stayed here illegally, they committed a host of crimes, and they sent proceeds back to Hezbollah.
Hezbollah terror cells in the U.S. We follow the money trail as millions in illegal cash is moved from our country to deep inside the heart of Lebanon.
I'm confident that Hezbollah would conduct an attack in this country.
Now our investigation exposes this network of well-trained, highly organized criminals. Watch Smokescreen, Hezbollah Inside America, hosted by David Asman.
Is Tinseltown leading towards Barack Obama in the name of Spielberg? Radio talk show host and extraordinary human being Laura Ingraham joins us right now from Washington, D.C. to explain why this may be a good thing for Senator Hillary Clinton, who wants to be president. She's also has her book Shut Up and Sing out in paperback. Laura, what do you mean if Barack Obama gets Hollywood's embrace, that's good for Senator Clinton?
Well, look, Hillary and Bill Clinton have had a great relationship with the entertainment industry for many, many years, gotten a lot of support, lots of fans out there. But I think you have to start asking yourself this question. Is Heartland America's values the same as Hollywood's values? Not to say that everybody in Hollywood is a crazy lefty. A lot of them are. But I think, you know, if George Clooney and David Geffen and Jeffrey Katzenberg are in your camp, it's not necessarily the case that you're going to be pushed over the top in the presidential race. I think it actually makes Hillary look a little bit more moderate if she's not the immediate darling of Hollywood right now.
Why do they get so political? Why don't they just, as you would say, shut up and sing, shut up and act, shut up and dance?
Well, look, these guys are multi-millionaires, some of them billionaires, and they think this is their way to exercise their political power from their positions of influence in the culture. And I can't really blame them. They're people. They can, you know, they can raise money and so forth, but we can expose how a lot of their views are silly and ridiculous.
Yeah, Steven Spielberg has his own, he retains his own political consultant full time.
Yeah, didn't it?
That's fascinating.
I saw that. I was thinking, that's like if I had my own entertainment consultant on my radio show. Isn't that bizarre?
Hi, how do I feel about this movie?
And by the way, depending on what Ailes is paying you guys, if you guys commit to raising $46,000 each for Barack Obama, you too can hang out at, I believe, is it David Geffen's house in Malibu on the 20th or Spielberg's house?
That's exactly right, because he's anybody who pays the extra dough will go to the private party.
Wouldn't that be fun? You can crash Barbara Streisand's house while you're there.
Hey, would we want to crash Tony Rodham's place? Because he's in trouble, the brother of the former First Lady.
Well, Tony Rodham, as you know, many years ago was involved, and this is going to test your Clinton trivia.
Okay.
What nut was at the center of a Hugh and Tony Rodham controversy about 8 years ago? What nut?
This is tough. I don't remember.
Go ahead.
Hazelnuts. Do you not remember this? The
hazelnut scandal
with the former Soviet Republic of Georgia. They were trying to use their influence to get this big hazelnut deal because of all of our love of hazelnut coffees and flavorings, apparently. So that was back then. And now it's that Tony Rodham owes about $109,000 to a carnival show, some type of United entertainment. I mean, what sibling? Which of us doesn't have a sibling that is in bankruptcy court to some carnival? You know, it's
absolutely. You get caught up in that short shot, even though the rim's so small. You think you can hit it. Next thing you know, you're down $100,000.
Yeah, the Clintons, the carnivals, the whack-a-moles. I mean, it's like the whack-a-mole. It just keeps coming back up. But the key thing about this is that President Clinton in 2000. Remember, he did those last-minute pardons.
Yeah.
The two owners of this particular carnival outfit were pardoned because they were convicted of defrauding the government.
Oh, it's got to be a coincidence.
Yeah, so it's there's no funny metaphor here.
Her book is out in paperback. It is called Shut Up and Sing. Laura Ingraham, we thank you very much for joining us
Thanks, guys.
Your big radio show.
Thank you.
Thanks, Laura.
Yeah, coming up straight ahead, where does Hillary Clinton stand in this week's political derby run for the White House in 08? Did you have a good week, bad week, in-between week?
Carnival music. Plus, a man so obsessed with science fiction, he went and built his own flying saucer. That's the prototype. He thinks it can fly.
Don't worry about those guys.
I am just so sick of this.
Dude, what do you expect? You went with Geico.com. What, to save some money?
It's my life, okay?
Just a little loyalty would be nice, that's all.
What? Having Geico makes me less of a caveman?
Tina's here. We're getting back together.
Hey, give us a minute.
Geico.com. So easy, a caveman can do it.
At Joseph A. Bank, take an extra 25% off every clearance price in the store. Wool suits, only $148.50. Dress shirts, sports shirts, and sweaters, $29.99. Plus, an extra bonus, sport coats, $94. That's $395 sport coats. Already clearance priced at $188, an incredible $94. Friday through Monday, only at Joseph A. Bank.
Feeling that big cold all over your body? Immerse yourself in total cold relief with Alka-Seltzer Plus. Liquid medicine that speeds relief to every inch of you for big relief fast. Alka-Seltzer Plus liquidates your big cold all over. Also available in liquid gel and new liquid.
Italian tomato with basil and a garlic soup. Fine, ripened tomatoes, gourmet spices, a restaurant quality taste. Campbell's a select golden label soup. A superlativo. And I'm not even Italian. Why settle when you can select?
Keep wandering eyes off your laptop. Reassuring, removable 3M privacy filters. Find yours at 3MPrivacyFilter.com.
I got breakfast.
Did you get a raise?
No, my treat.
Promotion? Bonus? Trust fund.
Getting breakfast just got easier. Right now, grab McDonald's tasty sausage biscuit for just $1.
Must be nice having a sugar mama.
When times get tough, companies and communities pull together. Something that Dominion has been doing for more than a century. Whether it's helping those in need through our Energy Share and Fan Care programs, working around the clock to provide electricity to neighborhoods, businesses, and communities all across our state, ensuring that you always get the best value for your energy dollars. Along with a reliable, friendly service, nearly 6 million Virginians have come to expect. Dominion. It all starts here.
Hey, it's only 2007. You're off to the races, Steve.
So are the candidates.
They are. And our next guest says the race for the White House makes it seem like it's already 2008. Joining us from D.C., editor of PoliticalDerby.com, Jason Wright. Good to see you for our horse segment, as we do every week, Jason. All right, let's start with the top GOP horses.
Well, no change from last week.
Mm-hmm.
We still have McCain in the number one spot. And in number two, Rudy. I think mm-hmm. he's picked up a little bit of steam. And then in three, Mitt Romney.
Mm-hmm. By the way, Jason, since you've started appearing on Fox and Friends, I understand your site is inundated with a lot of responses that you've never gotten before.
Absolutely. This week I was flooded with email from Apple fans, Apple geeks, they call themselves, all over the world, that were so excited with the prospect of a Steve Jobs candidacy. The blogosphere is just abuzz with talk of what Steve Jobs might name his cabinet members and whatnot. It's kind of interesting, a new demographic for you guys, probably.
Thank you.
All right. So
anything
let's look
I
at.
I can do to help.
You
let's
bet.
Do the top three Dem horses because I think we had some adjusting going on here.
Well, adjustment certainly in the momentum. I still have Hillary, Obama, and Edwards. I'll tell you, Edwards has to be really bothered, I think, by some of the recent polls. They show him trailing badly nationally, even though in Iowa he's up and polling pretty well.
Right.
If that doesn't depress him, then this guy is not capable of feeling emotion. I mean, he should be doing a lot. I mean, he's been in Iowa so much, frankly, he qualifies for in-state tuition. He's been there since 2004, basically nonstop,
yeah,
and still not polling well. I don't know.
You know what? I think this is the first week, Jason, where we've had a dead horse. And go ahead, tell us who the dead horse is.
Yeah, in fact, I meant to wear my black armband today in memory of John Kerry and his withdrawing from the race. I think this is a dark day all across the country.
Look at this.
We show
a skeletal horse.
The boniest horse in town. Look at that.
Yeah.
Also, today we've got a quirky horse. Wonder what it's riding on.
Dennis Kucinich. I thought it might be fun this week to focus on one of our horses in the 10th spot. He's running 10th among Democrats. This guy is the real cheese. I mean, he's good on the campaign trail. He's actually a pretty engaging speaker. People that have met him on a rope line say that he's pretty good. The problem is he's one of the few Americans that actually makes Rosie O'Donnell look sane. That's the problem.
Speaking of rope lines, I saw him try to shake the president's hand a couple of times at the State of the Union. You know, considering all the stuff that he said about the president, I'm amazed there was some handshaking.
Well, great FaceTime for him, absolutely.
All right.
All right, Jason, always good to see you, and we'll look forward to the horse picks next week. Have a
Thanks.
Good weekend.
Bye-bye.
Just ahead on the show, it's almost a month since his death. James Brown still hasn't been buried. What the heck is going on?
And they're keeping him in an air-conditioned room in his house. And the lifelong goal of one man to build a flying saucer. He really is doing it. He's spending a lot of money on it. We're live out there, and he's going to tell us all about his plan straight ahead on Fox and Friends.
Hey, it's Sleeping Beauty.
I didn't sleep a wink.
I know, we've been waiting for you. Have the chest set already?
He cheats.
Hello, Honest Abe.
Whatever.
We just haven't played for so long.
I know, I just got all this stress at work.
It's cool, it happens to a lot of people.
Really?
Absolutely. More than half of adults report experiencing some kind of insomnia at least a few nights a week.
We just want you back.
Thanks, guys.
When you can't sleep, you can't dream. That's why there's Rosarum, the first and only prescription sleep aid that in clinical studies shows no potential for abuse or dependence. Take it when you need it. Stop when you don't. Your doctor can explain why Rosarum is so different. Don't take Rosarum if you're taking Luvox, Fluvoxamine, or have severe liver problems. Avoid taking it with alcohol. Don't drive or operate machinery until you know how you'll react to Rosarum. Rosarum may affect some hormones. Consult your doctor about how this may affect you, or if your insomnia doesn't improve. Take Rosarum right before bed. Side effects may include drowsiness, fatigue, and dizziness.
Just talk to your doctor.
Today.
We've been to Cape Cod, Jersey Shore, East Coast Beach Tour,
Bloomington, Huntington, Family Reunion,
Ghost Town, Old West, get a load of Mom's Dress,
Florida, Kissimmee, Polka Dot Bikini,
Comfort Inn, Breakfast Free, finally is not a meme.
Mountains, we'll roam, don't feel like going home.
This spring, stay at any Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality Inn, Sleep Inn, or Clarion Hotel. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline rewards with your second stay. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels, we'll see you there.
Mommy doesn't make it like that.
This is the daddy way of making it.
Yeah, she chops everything up.
Well, the nice Jimmy Dean people chopped this for me.
Why?
Because I like making breakfast, but I don't always have time.
Why?
Because I have to be at work early to light and heat the earth.
The day begins with a happy breakfast. Delicious Jimmy Dean skillets. A weekend breakfast any day of the week.
Happy birthday!
Grow up.
It's time to ask your doctor about Rosarum.
There were strong signs of bipartisanship between Dick Cheney and Nancy Pelosi. Am I the only one that caught this?
What was that, man?
It looked to me, I don't want to start rumors.
Okay.
Well, you take a look.
The great question of our day is whether America will help men and women in the Middle East to build free societies, ensuring the rights of all humanity.
That is so great. I love that, especially when they cut back to Dick Cheney with the
smirk. Who's making the right face? Who knew they had a helicopter shot in there? By the way, the rest of that segment, hysterical, but we can't show it to you because it's really inappropriate.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, you can only imagine. All right, moving on to what the heck is going on with James Brown and his body, really? Is he resting in peace? Not really, because he's being kept in an air-conditioned room in his house while they battle out what's going to happen to where he's going to be buried and, I guess, his fortune, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much. It's always a squabble over money and final resting places. You know, there have been historically some other people who, through time, have not been buried immediately. And keep in mind, it's been almost a month since he's died.
And seems like yesterday, but it has been a month.
Yeah. Eva Perón, Argentina's first lady, died in 1952, but she was hidden in an army major's office and then sent to Spain and was not finally buried. Remember, she died in 52, wasn't buried until 74.
Wow.
I guess we don't have any Eva Perón video, but we have plenty of James Brown.
We should have Madonna played Eva Perón. Madonna, a singer, songwriter. Vladimir Lenin, a dictator that made communism cool for a while. Now, Lenin pictured there in the middle, dead. Don't ask him, don't call him. But they put stuff in him and preserved him, and they stuck him in a case, and they thought it was a good idea. Then when the Soviet Union fell apart and became Russia,
who wants him?
They thought, who wants Lenin's body now? Should we just bury him? A recent poll revealed that only 40% think they should be able to see Lenin anytime they want.
All right, what about Ted Williams, Brian?
He's in a meat locker.
When the Red Sox slugger,
no.
I don't think he is anymore, but remember his son wanted to preserve him, and apparently he had documentation from Ted himself that had signed off on that, but then the daughter said, hey, he always wanted to be cremated, and they went to court, and, you know, blah, blah, blah. It turned into a big, huge deal.
It wasn't a meat locker, which is the temperature of the studio right now here that we're in, but it was a cryogenic thing. And remember, they at one point, and this would have been a couple of years ago, they momentarily lost him, couldn't find him.
They did?
Yeah.
Yeah,
they
couldn't find
him.
They only kept his head.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they wanted, if they find a way to bring people back to life, they want to be able to have a really
cloning
good baseball player.
Or taking a little bit of him and then building a new thing, you know, 200, 300, 1,000 years from now.
Yeah, their son, he died. The guy that wanted to do this, the son, that he actually passed away. So I think they can bury Ted now, or at least his head.
I think that they did. I think it was settled. The question now is, when will James Brown be buried? And we'll continue to follow that story for you. In the meantime,
it's just so weird that he's
the daughter lost. It says the daughter lost the lawsuit, so his head is still out
somewhere out there. But James Brown is still in one of the air conditioned bedrooms at his house. That's just, you know, you would hate to break into that house.
And it's being guarded by security guards 24/7.
Oh yeah,
I feel good.
Thank you.
Pretty soon the estate money will be gone.
News time.
Yeah.
Gretchen.
Good morning. Here's what's new for you this morning. Schools and universities are closed in Lebanon this morning. After deadly clashes in Beirut, 4 people died. 200 were injured in yesterday's violence. A rare night curfew has now been lifted. A 2-year-old Kentucky girl is found safe after being forcibly taken from her babysitter. Police are still looking for 3 suspects, including the toddler's mother. Police say the kidnapping happened just hours after Lauren Connors was denied custody of her daughter. The search for missing 2-year-old Trenton Duckett is going international now. Detectives are looking to see if Duckett may have been taken to South Korea. He was last seen back in August in Florida. Drinking up to 3 cups of coffee a day is safe for pregnant mothers and their babies, says a new study by Danish scientists. They found moderate caffeine consumption doesn't lead to premature births or underweight babies. I'm not sure about that. I think a lot of doctors here in the U.S. would disagree with that study, but that's coming out of the Danish study.
Danish and coffee. Delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Greg Kelly joins us right now. He's down in our nation's capital. Good morning to you, Gregory.
Good morning, Steve and Brian and Gretchen. A major strategy session at the White House this morning. They'll be talking about the war on terror, the war in Iraq. The president will meet with his Secretary of Defense, the Joint Chiefs, and the incoming multinational force commander, General David Petraeus. But a raging debate continues about the president's plan to send more troops to Iraq. Now, overwhelmingly, Democrats oppose this plan. And there are also some key Republicans against it as well. Senator Chuck Hagel of Nebraska, a consistent administration critic. Also, Senator John Warner, former chairman of the Senate Armed Services Committee. He has come out against the president's proposal on troops. Now, debate soon heads to the floor of the United States Senate. The question has been raised, is the president facing a split in his own party? He still has significant party support. John McCain is one of the most vigorous proponents of more troops.
There's no compromise. There's no compromise. You either approve or you disapprove. I'm trying to put together something that exercises congressional oversight, that would provide some comfort to the American people, that there are certain benchmarks that are being met as far as measuring progress or lack of progress is concerned. And I don't view that as a compromise.
Now, in Baghdad yesterday, Prime Minister Maliki, in whom the administration at times has expressed doubts, yesterday he detailed a security plan for Baghdad. The plan was praised by the White House, but the meeting later erupted, really, near chaos. Maliki traded taunts and insults with some lawmakers. Maliki even accused some of those assembled of being involved in sectarian kidnappings. Iraq surely to come up later today as the president meets with congressional Republicans in a private retreat in Maryland. Steve, back to you.
All right, Greg Kelly, we thank you very much. Quickly, take a look. It's cold throughout the Northeast. And in fact, right now, outside our window in New York City, it's sunshiny. And man, is it cold. People are all bundled up. The wind chill, it feels like it's about 10 to 20 degrees below zero throughout the New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut area. Right now in Buffalo, had a little bit of lake effect snow overnight. And that will continue through the afternoon hours. Only 20 there. Meanwhile, Wilmington to North Carolina, almost 50. Down through portions of Florida, temperatures in the 60s. All these reporting stations nice and dry. Dallas should top out at 60. Wichita's going for a high in the 40s and up north some 20s and 30s. Out west also dry as well. Boise in Idaho, 44, almost 70 in Los Angeles. Vegas, 63, and Seattle, 52. And unlike yesterday, today it's going to be dry. He's standing in his light, and Brian Kilmeade will be doing the sports in just a moment. But speaking of good sports, Dr. Manny's got a great new book out. It's called The Checklist. Here, every home needs it. We will send you a free copy of it if you can answer this question. What new male fashion trend did we tell you about yesterday on Fox and Friends? It was being portrayed on the catwalks of Milan yesterday. It's the latest fashion trend for guys. What is it? Be the first to email us at friendsatfoxnews.com, and we will send you a copy of this book. If you'd like to get your own copy, go to Amazon, barnesandnoble.com, Books a Million, or your local bookstore. All right, Brian Kilmeade. Now, with the sports.
Yeah, we're going to wait about an hour. We got to go through all the applications, see if we get the right answer to release the winner. Meanwhile, let's talk tennis. They play in the middle of the night in Australia. I haven't figured it out. They have an update, and here we go. We have the final set on the women's side and on the men's side. And it is Thomas Haas has lost, we understand. But first, the NBA star, who finished second in the All-Star voting, sure knows how to hold a grudge. I'm talking about Gilbert Arenas. He says he would give up a full season to go back to school and teach Duke's coach Mike's
Krzyzewski a lesson. The Washington Wizards point guard still steamed over Coach K cutting him from the U.S. national team. Arenas figures he can score 84 and 85 points against the Blue Devils. Another reason to stay in school. It's straight to jail for Cincinnati Bengals wide receiver Chris Henry. I actually had him on my fantasy team. He has to spend 2 days behind bars for giving booze to minors. This on top of a drunk driving charge he had to settle. He's among 9 Cincinnati Bengal players who popped up on the police blotter this past year. There's another arrest this week. 10th seeded Fernando Gonzalez will meet number 1 seed Roger Federer in the men's final of the Australian Open. This after the Chilean dominated Germany's Tommy Haas 6-1, 6-3, 6-1 in the semis down under. Roger Federer is in there. On the women's side, it's going to be a great matchup. Serena Williams turns back the clock and will take on top seeded Maria Sharapova for the Grand Slam title.
I would love to watch that. I'll tell you that.
I know. Mike Ditka said that he was almost late because he had to get up. Got up at 2 o'clock in the morning just to watch the final live, and then got ready for a show.
Very compelling.
So it was fantastic.
All right, 22 minutes now before the top of the hour on this Friday.
In gambling, people say the house always wins, but our next guest says, hey, not so fast. Stephen Wilkinson's on the phone from Feasterville, Pennsylvania, with his story about the slots, his big win, and then the casino controversy, because they said, hey, you didn't really win. Stephen, good morning to you.
How you doing? Good morning.
So tell us what happened when you pulled down the lever and saw that you won 102 grand.
What happened was it was actually not through the machine, it was through the promotion. It was actually on the screen up top. It flashed, my name flashed across. And also, I said, congratulations, you're the Player Power Jackpot winner.
Congratulations.
$102,000. I came across again and again. And then the machine lit up, started singing, and then on the machine itself, it says, hand-paid patron, 408,000 quarters.
Wow.
And was at your that time, it says, press button for attendant. I hit the button for the attendant. The attendant come over. She seen my name and the number go across the screen. She's congratulating. Congratulations, you're the big winner. Another attendant came over, same thing. Another girl came over. She got on the radio. She said, I'm calling the manager, letting them know where you're at, and they'll be coming over shortly with a check. I said, all right. I said, finally. And then we're all there. People around me are happy. We're all... Then about 15 minutes goes by, another girl comes by with a radio. She's looking at the machine. I said, is there a problem? She says, no, I'm just checking things out. 15 minutes after that, two techs come. They were standing there. I said, sorry, Mr. Wilkinson, this was a mistake. We were running a test on the system, and that you didn't get anything. I said, you got to be kidding me.
Yeah.
I said, you better get the manager over here. The manager comes over. He says, he apologizes. I'm sorry. You know, this was a mistake, but I'm going to take care of you. He says, I'm going to give you 2 comps to the buffet. I said, you got to be kidding. I said, you better get somebody else over here.
Right.
So then about 10 minutes goes by, the girl that was the rep for the vendors who supplies all the machines, she came over. She says to me, listen, our lawyer's on the way. I said, all right, I would like you to come downstairs with us and talk about this in our office. And I said, I don't think so. I said, I'm not leaving this machine. I said, do me a favor. I said, tell your lawyer, come meet me here. And by the way, would you please get the Gaming Commission down here? I want them to see this, to visually see this, so I have some sort of proof that I did win this money.
Well, now, okay, so the machine itself did not say that you were the winner, but the big screen above
it's the screen, it's a promotion that they just started on Sunday, and this happened on Monday.
And it had your name on it.
My name, yes.
So it looked like you won. And it, you know what? If I was standing right there, I'd think the same thing.
So did everybody else that was standing there, too.
So what are you going to do? If you know, are you? It's too late to collect on the free buffet lunches. You blew that
out. That's one hell of a buffet. Huh?
Yeah, no kidding. They've got 19 different salad items. So what are you going to do? Are you going to sue them?
I was waiting to see if they would do the right thing. They've never even contacted me at all. They, you know, once, you know, that was it. I called them back on Tuesday. They said, since I called the Inquirer, that was it. They had nothing else to say to me. They're going to wait to see how this played out.
Well, Stephen, guess what? Stephen, you're going to have a chance to talk to the other side, because we're going to have the other side of this casino controversy coming up. Right after this commercial break, we're going to talk to a spokesperson from the casino.
Yeah.
Stay on the lives, Stephen, because we want you to be able to ask some questions as well.
All right.
Plus, coming up straight ahead on Friday's Fox and Friends, a Michigan man claims he has invented a flying saucer. Remember, we've heard all these stories about lights in the sky over, we've heard about it over Arkansas, and then something over this O'Hare Airport. And yesterday, there were reports of lights in the sky in Charlotte, North Carolina. Well, this guy building a flying saucer. You'll see it live and only on this show.
This is a classical design we did in Milan.
Residence in
five
Eastern.
Prestigious awards. So, what can I do for you?
Design a house around this.
Forget fine lines. It's deep wrinkles that make us look older. Neutrogena Anti-Wrinkle Intensive Serum delivers four times the retinol to help fill in the look of even the deepest wrinkles. Don't let deep wrinkles tell your age. Anti-Wrinkle Intensive Serum. Neutrogena.
People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals are known for their outrageous campaigns. But official government records show that PETA itself has killed more than six animals every working day since 1998. PETA employees now face felony animal cruelty charges for killing puppies and kittens and throwing many of them in a dumpster. Now you know, PETA kills animals and is using your donations to do it. Find out more at PETAKillsAnimals.com.
All right, international shipping. Well, your products are on a plane, ready to go to your customers in Europe to arrive on Friday. But Italy wants it there by noon, Paris early morning, and London late afternoon. Well, if you had a UPS logo, now when your customers ask, you can say, si, oui, and yes. It's not international shipping. It's international shipping with UPS. You even got a little tailwind.
For party today, Grandpa.
Thank you.
Not yet. Oh, okay. Do you miss Macy? Do you miss Ribbon?
Oh, good.
And I'll give one to myself.
Well, why do I have to wait?
Grandpa, ladies first.
Oh, I knew that. Why don't we have tea?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
I have high blood pressure. But I was surprised to find out it might lead to erectile dysfunction.
You think you know everything about diabetes, but no one ever told me it could lead to ED.
So I talked to my doctor. He said that certain health conditions like high blood pressure
or diabetes may lead to ED.
And that Levitra can help.
Doctors know Levitra works for men with ED, even those with high blood pressure or diabetes. Levitra is only for men healthy enough for sexual activity. If you have heart problems or are on alpha blocker therapy, talk to your doctor before taking Levitra. Do not take Levitra if you take nitrates for chest pains, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Side effects may include headache, flushing and stuffy or runny nose. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help if you experience an erection lasting longer than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease in vision, stop taking Levitra and call your doctor right away.
Talking to my doctor took a lot off my mind.
You should talk to your doctor about Levitra.
The more you know about ED, the more you'll want to know about Levitra.
Welcome back, everyone. We just heard from Stephen Wilkinson. He said he thought he won $102,000, but the casino refuses to pay it out. Let's hear from the Philadelphia Park Casino spokesperson, Darlene Monzo. Good to see you, Darlene.
Hi, Steve, Gretchen, and Brian. Glad to be here. Thank you.
So it sounds like you're in a little bit of a pickle here. This guy says that he won. His name flashed across the board, $102,000. Other people thought he won, and then you said no dice.
Well, no, not exactly. No dice.
That's right. You did offer him two free buffets.
Only as comfort food. When he was approached, when we became aware of the incident, immediately as a customer service approach, we did invite him for two at the buffet. That was right after we self-reported this incident to the Pennsylvania Gaming Control Board. And we thought he'd be a little bit comfortable having some dinner while we were walking through it with casino officials.
Yeah, but he said, hey, I'm not leaving that machine because then I won't be able to prove that I ever won this. And I think that was kind of a smart move on his part.
Well, we're not disputing whether we are not going to pay him or not. We are well aware that there was a communication issue.
Right.
It happened on a small screen at the bottom of the slot machine.
Right. And it
basically
flashed his name.
Yes, it flashed his name. It did flash the $102,000. And I think the hardest part of our staff that day was having to tell him that he wasn't a winner.
Right. Well, we
they didn't go into their
you.
Normal mode of celebration.
Well, I can understand it's hard for you to tell someone they didn't win $102,000. But did it happen to anybody else?
Well, you mean the $102,000
or the jackpot? Yeah, did anybody else win during your test period?
No, this was an isolated incident at this gentleman's slot machine.
Right.
And the event itself, the play, the power player promotion didn't actually happen at that moment. It happened about an hour and a half later, and the event that takes place is a big celebration on the floor.
Right.
The employees come marching in, and they have a big check, and they have balloons, and both floors of the casino, everyone wins on this promotion. So each individual player that has their card in the slot machine gets a chance to win.
Gotcha. All right. So, Darlene, it sure looked like he won. He thought he won. What are you going to do to make it right? Because, you know, for the folks watching right now, I would say a bunch of them probably think he should get the money.
Yeah, and we're not disputing that right now.
So are you going to give him the money?
Are you a heavily regulated industry.
I understand. Are you going to give him the money?
It is being investigated right now. We can't make that call on our own. The Pennsylvania Gaming Control gets involved.
Okay.
They investigate the slot machine. They determine whether a jackpot was hit.
Right.
Now, normally the reels line up.
When will they
have the verdict? And we understand this wasn't that type of promotion.
When will they have the verdict, Darlene? When will they have the verdict?
I can't speak for them. Okay. I know that we're doing our own internal investigation as well.
Okay.
And once we have both parties' decision, and we really need the gaming controls first, and then finally, you know, you just can't decide on your own that you're going to pay a jackpot.
Right, Darlene?
Unfortunately, Stephen wasn't available the next day, and attorneys got involved.
I gotcha.
But we have him on the other end.
Yeah, that's right.
Thanks, Darlene. He's on the line.
Darlene,
let's see what he thinks.
Darlene, we understand, we understand the whole thing where you can't just give the money out. You got to go through the state. We understand that, so we're glad that you're going to do the right thing. And if they say you're going to pay them, you're going to pay them. All right. Now we're going
to absolutely. If they say we need to pay them, we absolutely will. We've given actually over $7.6 million in jackpots already in only a month of opening.
Okay, Darlene, thank you so much. We want to. Oh, I guess we're going to take a break, and we're going to bring Stephen back to respond to what we heard just now from Darlene. It sounds like he still has a chance, potentially, of getting this $102,000.
Yeah.
It's all up to the Gaming Commission now. Maybe we should be talking to the Gaming Commission next.
Yeah, and also, straight ahead, we're going to tell you, and you're going to hear from the guy who's making this in flying saucer, and it could be out of this world.
Beep, 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 beep.
Happy to see you. I'm looking for options, investment options, a range from someone with experience like you. My money is in it for the long term.
Ah, you come to the wrong place. You want the Van Kampen Lighthouse.
Look for the right lighthouse. Van Kampen Investments. Call your advisor for a prospectus. Please read it carefully and consider fund objectives, risks, charges, expenses, and other information before investing.
What's your cereal's IQ? It's an odd question, but some cereals are brighter than others. When it comes to your heart, Smart Start is pretty intelligent. It's designed to help lower cholesterol. Smart, right? But what makes it a heart health scholar? It has potassium and low sodium to help lower blood pressure, too. Pretty simple and very smart. And did I tell you how great it tastes? I didn't? How dumb of me.
Kellogg Smart Start Healthy Heart. For your heart, start...
Comcast high-speed internet has Power Boost?
Yep, makes their already fast downloads even faster. I'd prefer a power nap, to be honest.
Or power that abruptly slows down so you can rest.
Mm-hmm.
And do Sudoku.
She's a Sudoku maniac.
I am.
Comcast high-speed internet now with Power Boost makes fast faster. It's Comcasting.
Will today be the day a little boy who sorts through garbage finally gets something decent to eat? Will today be the day a little girl who's been sick for weeks finally gets to see a doctor? But for so many of these children, today has to be the day. Because without your phone call, there's a good chance they won't live to see tomorrow. Please call Christian Children's Fund now and see to it that one of these children finally has a chance for a better life. Make one phone call and save one child for just 80 cents a day. $24 a month. You know we won't stop asking, that you'll have other chances to call. Please don't let a child's only chance for a better life pass her by. Make today the day you pick up that phone and change a child's life.
relied on each other. Him on me and me on him. When he died, I had to rely on a funeral home that knew what to do, because I didn't. I needed to know that they had enough experience, enough people, enough compassion. I needed to know that he could rely on me one last time.
At Nelson Funeral Home and Crematory, we will be there to listen, to comfort, to give you more for your money.
We were talking a little while ago with Stephen Wilkerson on Monday. It looked like he won $102,000 at a casino by the name of Philadelphia Park. Stephen, we were just talking to their PR person, and they say that if the State Gaming Commission says that they are at fault, they will give you the $102,000.
Well, that's the first positive thing I've heard from him. That sounds good anyway.
All right.
I mean, the comment on what you said, I mean, I might not have had the balloons and all that, but there are people from the casino. As soon as I hit that attendant button, they were there.
Yep,
and
absolutely.
Three of them did come up to me. They were congratulating me, telling me I won. You know, what right. I think happened is, I mean, I've had a lot of people, I had a lot of support, a lot of people calling. I've had people call me that work right. for casinos in Atlantic City that are behind the scenes. Well, and he said a couple of things is, there's no yeah. way a tech should have been on the floor talking to me. They think
right.
they screwed up.
Exactly.
And I actually did win that jackpot, but when they saw that amount that they made a mistake, that's when they
but
started.
Sure.
Discussion.
And Stephen, I tell you what, Stephen, we're going to be watching it, and we'll keep folks updated. Good luck to you. Thank you. Stephen Wilkerson. Hope he gets the money. All right. Some may call it strange, but this one Michigan man believes his invention is the pathway to the future. With us from Clinton Township, Michigan, is flying saucer inventor Alfie Carrington. Hi, Alfie.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. Alfie, a while back over in Chicago, some O'Hare employees at United spotted a flying saucer over the airport. Was that you?
Might have been my cousin, maybe. I don't know. But no, it wasn't me. But we're still working on it, though. We expect to be seen anytime.
Show me your saucer. What do you got there?
Basically, this is a vertical lift saucer.
Yeah.
It's based on a Frisbee.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, it's a cross between a helicopter and a Learjet.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Alfie, how the heck do you ever get this yes. idea that you want to build a flying saucer?
Basically, I'm a sci-fi person,
right.
a Trekkie, and I was completely disturbed by science fiction when the people are at the controls and then they show the outside of the vehicle,
right.
and it looks so phony.
Yeah, right. You know, Alfie,
so I decided.
The reason we're doing this is yesterday there were reports that in Charlotte, North Carolina, lights in the sky. We did a story a couple of weeks ago about lights in the sky over Arkansas.
Yeah.
And then the thing at the airport in Chicago. Do you think there are flying saucers out there from other places other than Michigan?
Definitely. But because basically flying saucers are designed basically like the universe. They're circles, they're ovals. They are planets like Saturn, and basically those shapes are basically what we're using here.
Right. So
universal shapes.
Where's your engine? I know you use Frisbee technology, but where's the engine, or do you look for a giant slingshot to launch it?
Slingshot would be good, but we're going to use a Wangle engine, probably something from the RX-7, RX-8, Mazda.
Yeah.
Something like that. And we're going to start it that way, and then we're going to use an induction motor, much like electromagnetic.
Yep.
Hey, Alfie,
like
do you have to get permission to do that? Do you have to, like, call
permission
up?
To what?
Yeah, do you have to call up, like, somebody who controls airspace and say, I'm going to be sending off a flying saucer?
You know, that's going to become an issue, but only when we get a lot of these up in
right,
the air.
Right. Now, you need $60,000 more dollars, right? You need $60,000 to finish this off, or $50,000 to $100,000. Where's the guy? Or is it a woman that you have flying your saucer?
No, this is my buddy. Tony's in there is what's happening.
Who's Tony?
Is he an earthling?
Tony's my assistant. Huh?
Is he an earthling?
Tony's my assistant. Huh?
Oh, never mind.
Yeah, he's an earthling, definitely.
Hey,
can you hear me?
Yeah, we sure can. Alfie, what do friends and relatives think about you spending tens of thousands of dollars on a flying saucer? Do they think you're nuts?
They think I'm mad, definitely. What can I say?
And what do you tell them?
That's the case. I tell them that, hey, you know, I think that this is the way we're going to be moving around in the future.
Hey, they laughed at the Wright brothers.
Alfie, I think you need to get a patent.
They did laugh at the right
get business. A patent now.
Well, I got two of those already.
Cool.
All right, it just flies one, correct, Alfie?
Pardon me?
It just flies one. You have to fly your saucer alone.
No, we can get four in here.
You can get you Tony, and two other guys in there?
Fantastic.
Well, we can get four people. What they do is they sit back to back to back in the center.
Right.
And they sit facing out.
All right, very good.
We can get four in there, but basically.
I'd love to try
this one will carry four.
All right, I know that's what they're using in the Martians can carry eight. You got to up your capacity.
Right, but they're little green men.
Alfie Carrington, we thank you very much for joining us from Clinton Township, Michigan.
And thanks for telling us what it's all about.
That is so cool. You know how people pay millions to go up into space?
I know Alfie.
No, millions, like $20 million. I wonder who would go up in space with Alfie on that little space thing.
I think he's going to have to stay on the ground. He's got to send his friends up to space.
That's right.
My buddy.
All right, straight ahead on Fox. Yeah, there's Alfie. See you later. Coming up, never mind who you'd vote for. Which of the presidential hopefuls would you have dinner with and you would like to break the bread with?
He's using a Mazda engine, correct?
Plus, should there be a bill of rights for airline passengers? Yeah, what happens when you get stuck on the tarmac for like 10 hours? I hope you don't have a screaming kid. We're going to talk about the legal ramifications right when we come back.
When you smile. Award-winning printers and copiers so advanced, they're simple. Kyocera gives you new reasons to smile. Brilliant color. Low cost of ownership. That's the power of people-friendly. Only from Kyocera.
This is my cat, Harold.
Uh-huh.
This is him eating.
Uh-huh.
And this is him sleeping.
What's his favorite?
You want a sombrero? Peppermint?
The taste you love, anywhere you go. Campbell's Microwavable Soup at Hand Soup.
We know how stressful moving can be. That you want your property treated with care. That you need to get your life back in order quickly. That's why you call two men in a truck. We can move just one item from room to room, clear a room for painting, just rearrange the furniture, or we can move everything. When you need friendly, reliable moving services from home or business, call two men in a truck. Movers who care.
At Joseph A. Bank, take an extra 25% off every clearance price in the store. Wool suits, only $148.50. Dress shirts, sports shirts, and sweaters, $29.99. Plus, an extra bonus, sport coats, $94. That's $395 sport coats. Already clearance priced at $188, an incredible $94. Friday through Monday, only at Joseph A. Bank.
Escape to a world of vibrant color, captivating design, and luxurious style with Stainmaster carpet. Experience a whole new era in style and beauty for your home. Stainmaster carpet, always stylish, always beautiful. For a retailer near you, visit stainmaster.com.
Yeah, we got the shipment. You bet. That's the third time he's called today.
Yeah, it's a good thing we got free incoming calls from Sprint. Saves us enough money to cover other costs.
Like
your nephew.
That's a great plan.
Sprint has free incoming plans for business. Singular doesn't. And for every Sanyo 7000 you buy, we'll give you one free. Visit sprint.com/business.
Sprint. Power up.
What the people need is a way to make them smile. It ain't so hard to do if you know how. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Listen to the music. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Listen to the music all the time.
Come listen to the music. Call 1-800-BRANSON or visit explorebranson.com.
Hey, good morning. Today on Fox and Friends, forget about who you want to win the White House in 2008. How about which candidate do you want to share a meal with? We're going to reveal who's tops when it comes to a dinner date. And Why work out when you can go under the knife? That is, if you're willing to take an IQ test first. We'll break down the details brick by brick. And one state wants to make spanking illegal. We'll meet the mom who's not afraid to say, I spanked my kid and I'll pay in advance. This is Fox and Friends.
This is Joel Fulton, your stage manager.
Sono Joel Fulton, vostro manager di produzione.
And you're watching Fox and Friends.
E state guardando Fox and Friends.
Wow. There you go, simultaneous translation.
That's the woman that tells me my door's open.
Thank you very much, Joel. Door is ajar.
Speaking of spanking, you
there
guys.
There you go.
We're going to be talking about this debate coming up. In California, they want to make it illegal to spank your child. I'm not sure how they would know if you did or not, you know, and be able to enforce that. But, you know, I think every parent goes through this absolute turmoil about whether or not to do this.
Right.
And I think this is one of these things that society has put pressure on us now to make us feel like we shouldn't spank no matter what. We all grew up getting spankings, right?
Routinely.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so now, in fact, just yesterday, my 3.5-year-old decided to act up in public. And I was so embarrassed. And it went through my mind, you know, would I spank her if it wasn't like this whole public outcry?
A lot of parents
erupt. Yeah, but I didn't, because I think now parents think in the back of their head, oh, I'm not supposed to do this because society tells me I'm not supposed to do this. And so very interesting debate coming up.
And this is a woman without kids, too, correct?
No, she has
children.
Kids.
She absolutely
has children.
Hey, we've given all of our kids a SWAT on the behind after they ran in traffic, and you know, you have to drive home a point. That's a very serious thing. Also, something we were talking about: the state of New Jersey warning people don't eat more than 2 squirrel per week because of the high lead concentration. I cannot tell you how many people have emailed us that you are. People who do eat squirrel, in fact, James Wilson in Elmore, Alabama. Gretchen, I heard your comment about eating squirrel earlier. Child, you're missing a gastronomical delight. My wife makes the best squirrel dumplings, fried squirrel, and squirrel head gravy and biscuits.
Squirrel head gravy
in your mouth.
Well, first of all, what I got out of that email was that he called me child, didn't he?
Yeah,
child. Thank you. I won't share my age, but I'm definitely not.
You know what?
Child.
If Emerald's watching, I think it's a special. A lot of people are eating it.
Meanwhile, put down the swordfish, grab the squirrel.
4 minutes after the top of the hour, time for some headlines with that gal.
All right, here's the child. In just about an hour, President Bush meets with the Secretary of Defense and the Joint Chiefs Chairman, along with incoming Iraq Commander Lieutenant General David Petraeus. He's the new guy. The Senate's expected to vote to confirm him in his new position this morning. Later, the president will address House Republicans who are holding a retreat in Maryland for a Q&A session. A bomb rips through the Marriott Hotel in Pakistan's capital, killing at least 2 and injuring at least 5 others. Police believe the attacker is one of the dead. The Senate approves a plan preventing companies that hire illegal immigrants from receiving government contracts. Anyone caught breaking the rule would be banned from getting any other contract for 10 years. Venezuelan President Hugo Chavez threatens to kick out the U.S. ambassador there. Chavez accused him of meddling. That's the pot calling the kettle black. The ambassador wants U.S. investors to be fairly compensated when Venezuela's phone company is nationalized. Well, which candidate for president do you want to have over for dinner? It's much more important, apparently, than whether or not they're popular. Who do you want to have a conversation with over turkey stuffing and a little squirrel?
All right. Yeah, fine. Yeah, if you're having squirrel, what else do you need to talk about? You got to focus on the squirrels. Want to try the head?
Tastes like chicken.
Hey,
only in the gravy.
So who is up for this award? Okay, that's true.
Well, Sam Brown back.
Right. Sam Brown.
Duncan Hunter.
If you get the squirrel, that's the booby prize. Go right to the kitchen and get more. You got Brown. Oh, you got Sam Brown back.
You know what?
Didn't win.
Are so many people who are running for president right now. Maybe we should just cut to the chase.
Who wins?
Hillary Clinton. According to this new poll out, 26% of you would like to have break bread with Hillary. Meanwhile, John McCain and Barack Obama both tied at 15%.
I had no knowledge of that whatsoever.
All right, thank you very much, Mrs. Clinton.
But she's got to be pleased by it.
Also, Al Sharpton says unless the candidates decide that they are going to come out in a big way and focus on civil rights, he may jump in and look out below.
Uh-oh.
Keep in mind, in the South Carolina primary last time around, he did come in third, so he has placed, but does anybody really
Al Sharpton will be on the show on Sunday, so maybe we'll get him to announce that he's going to run for president. Here's what I want to know, though. Why do people want to have dinner? I mean, what makes it that you want to have dinner with a particular candidate? Is it because you want all the gossip of what happened in the White House?
Rather than soundbite, it's just a bite.
No, but really, why? Because the most popular person in the same poll was not Hillary Clinton, it was Rudy Giuliani.
By a staggering amount, 82% of those Democrats and Republicans who take this poll said Rudy, he was their guy. Very few negatives, where the negatives for Senator Hillary Clinton was extremely high, around 40%. But here's the thing that I don't get. You have Barack Obama, black, and you have Senator Hillary Clinton, not black, yet the black vote right now, 57-23 for Hillary Clinton. Don't you think, as Barack Obama proves himself as a viable candidate, if he does, the longer he goes, that'll start balancing out, and that could really tip the overall scales.
And when it comes to negatives, the number one most negative candidate, potential candidate, polled was Al Gore, followed by Hillary Clinton. Al has 43%. Hillary Clinton has 41% negatives. Meanwhile, let's talk a little bit about a scandal that has been brewing across the street at NBC. Their treasurer has been charged with stealing more than $800,000. The guy's name is Victor Jung. He's a former treasurer,
of NBC
obviously
Universal.
No longer working there. But man, this guy was audacious.
Took the treasure.
Yeah.
He was the treasurer of NBC Universal, that is. I think, what do you call that? Like a spinoff of NBC?
Yeah, the movie division. Syndication company.
It's all part of GE. And what he did was he concocted this company on his own called NBCU, which, you know, the company, there are companies called NBC and Universal, and they're combined. So it looked real. And so he wrote a whole bunch of checks over to himself, essentially, bought fancy air rides on jets, marquee jets, a house in the Hamptons, all together. One day he transferred to himself $575,000. The next day, $387,000 worth of marquee jets.
And that's allegedly, right?
Allegedly,
yeah,
yes.
It's very specific for allegedly, but we're going to go with that.
You know, his family, and he is a married man, so I don't know, as a spouse, would you not start wondering that you suddenly came into a lot of money?
Well, NBC is a major company. Must be thinking, wow, they really take care of their executives, and boy, I picked the right guy. Also, something else is going on there, and this Maria Bartiromo, the
money honey.
The money honey is still knee-deep in this scandal, evidently. It's already cost a wealth manager that cleared people off a jet flight so she could fly with him over to Hong Kong, cost him his job. But now this thing continues to be a fallout because three different times she spoke for an advertiser, Citigroup.
Yeah, I know it. And the New York Times today is saying that it's unusual for a financial journalist, as she is, to make public appearances on behalf of a major advertiser, and Citibank, a big advertiser. Also, New York Times reporting today that last year, an executive from Citibank, toward the end of last year, called NBC and said, Maria Bartiromo is never getting a free ride on another one of our jets. And remember, this one guy who got fired, Todd Thompson, had kicked a couple of other guys off the jet so she could ride with him. And you've got to...
That's clout.
And here's the thing. NBC and GE, their ethics department said, oh, it's fine. They're not breaking any rules. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Seemed pretty cozy.
Yeah. Also, switch... okay. I'm not switching gears, I guess. We're talking about just real quick, Danny. This Major General Rick Lynch with the 3rd Infantry was interviewed yesterday about the war. He's going back again, I think, for the third time with his men and women to win this war. He says America should prepare themselves for the conflict to last for years. And most importantly, they should stop complaining. It's the men and women in the military who are the ones sacrificing, and they are not complaining. It's everyone outside that is complaining. So just pipe down and let us fight this war, because it's going to be a while and it's going to be hard, and you're making it worse.
Yeah, he says history shows that it takes what he's predicting is 9 years to complete any counterinsurgency. So it could be that we're going to be over there for a little bit longer time.
Well, at least we're taking on Iran now directly. More on that later. 11 minutes after the hour, let's take on Steve. You take on the weather.
Thank you very much, Brian Kilmeade. Very cold in the Northeast right now at LaGuardia. Look at that. 9 degrees plus the wind chill throughout the Northeast. It feels like it's way below zero. Chicago has 23. Let me get out of the way. West Coast, you're stuck in the 40s. Meanwhile, the Doppler, for the most part, nice and dry across much of the country. We do have a little bit of lake effect snow moving through portions of Michigan. Not uncommon for this time of the year. We also had a little bit of snow move through the Northeast overnight. Just watch the time lapse. There it goes. For the most part, things are nice and dry. There is a little action out in West Virginia. Snow-wise, I should point out. There's a little action snow-wise in West Virginia. Down south, the only wetness behind me. Look at that around El Paso. Just a little bit of rain right out there. For the most part, today in the southern plains, we're going to have temperatures in the 50s and 60s, 20s and 30s across the northern plains, 40s and 50s across the central plains. It's going to continue to be very cold throughout the northeast today. Coldest day of this year. 24 the high for New York, Cleveland 26, 50s and 60s down south. A nice day all in all in Orlando, Florida. 64 should be the daytime high. One more panel is going to show you folks out in the middle your selected highs, and here they are. I'll have the West Coast after we have the winner. Remember I told you about a little while ago, whoever sent us the correct answer to the question, what new male trend did we talk about yesterday on our program? The answer, men in tights. The winner, Sally McCoy from Grove City, Ohio. And so, Sally, we're going to send you a copy of The Checklist, Dr. Manny's book, which you can get everywhere, so please check it out. And ladies and gentlemen, when I think men in tights, I think Brian Kilmeade, don't you?
Can we please? That was a moment they asked me to take my shirt off and pose. I had no idea what they were doing, what they were up to, so I was really had.
So how do you do
that? Some very good form, though.
You know what? It's called removing your spine, and also I spent years on the female gymnastics circuit.
I had no idea you're a waxer.
Huh?
You're a waxer.
No time. We only have 27 seconds. I wish I could. If I could only unbutton this shirt quickly, if I had Velcro instead of buttons.
That's okay. Don't bother.
Thank you.
All right, coming up on the show, inside details of the GOP's plan to win back power in Congress, the behind-the-scenes scoop, it's right ahead.
I'll take it from here, girl. Plus, angry passengers push for an airline bill of rights. We'll expose their demands. You're watching Fox News Channel. This is not a test.
You look like a girl in that shot.
Wow.
Excuse me, I didn't know Milan came with all-wheel drive.
Yeah, you can't get that on Camry or Accord.
Wow, it had me just on the looks.
Mercury Milan's the only car in its class with all-wheel drive, six airbags, and anti-lock brakes.
It's a great find.
Now lease Mercury Milan for just $208 a month. And click on mercuryvehicles.com for more reasons why.
You've got to put Mercury on your list.
The critics have spoken. Letters from Iwo Jima is the best film of 2006. Nominated for four Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Original Screenplay, and Best Director, Clint Eastwood. Winner of the Golden Globe Award and the Critics' Choice Award for Best Picture of the Year. Four stars, a triumph, Flags of Our Fathers, and Letters from Iwo Jima is one complete masterpiece. Letters from Iwo Jima, rated R, now playing.
Give it 3:30. I got soccer.
Oh, look at that.
Here, honey. Who wants one? Honey, would you like one? Last one here. And then I'm taking you to Zach's. Right? So we'll do that. And then we'll go to the mall, pick up I'll get that for you, little buddy. There we go. There it is. Where's my bun? What can make me feel? Is that my honey bun? Did you teach him that?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
Oh, Sharon, this stuff won't get rid of the mold in here.
Will it help you forget our address?
There's a better way to deal with your mold problem.
Can you pass me the brush?
Tyrants, the mold killer.
It's the latest Paris Peep Show online, the videos she doesn't want you to see.
Dirty.
But it's not just the famous that have to worry. Your most intimate personal life could be exposed to the world. It's your not-so-private privacy. Bill investigates on the next O'Reilly Factor. It's the video Bill Clinton doesn't want you to see. His outrage over this 9/11 docudrama forced ABC to cut out an entire scene. Now, for the first time on TV, we expose the clip at the center of the controversy. The exclusive video is on Hannity's America.
Welcome back. How can the House Republicans take back Congress? They're all at a retreat right now, working out a strategy just to do that on the Eastern Shore, and it's chilly out there.
Isn't another company on a retreat? Is everybody on a retreat except us? At Paradise Island, joining us.
That company's on a tropical retreat.
That's right, at Paradise Island. That must be cheap. Hey, we're talking about the retreat in Cambridge, Maryland. Is someone who should just give some good advice. He's going to be speaking today, right and along with the president. Former Representative Bob Walker, Republican out of Pennsylvania, now a lobbyist. What should the message be, or what do you think the message is for Republicans to get back on their feet?
Well, I think the Republicans really need to figure out some themes that will carry them through the legislative battles. Republicans are all about families and opportunity, and they are for reduced taxes. They want security. They want growth in the economy. They want competition. All of those are themes that can be used as a way of countering some of the legislative initiatives that are going to come from the Democrats.
And Bob, you're an expert at this, speaking of themes, because back in the day when you were in the House, you and Newt Gingrich and a whole bunch of other Republicans came up with the Contract with America, which America found very interesting, and you won.
Well, that was the kind of thing that we found worked for you when you're in the minority. It's very different being in the minority in the Congress than being in the majority, because you don't set the legislative agenda. And so therefore, you have to have the kinds of things that both react to the agenda that's being set for you, and at the same time, put a positive vision out of what you want to do. And the Contract with America and some of the initiatives that we had even before the contract were aimed at doing just that.
Well, something's out of your hand. Many experts believe this is all about Iraq.
Well, right now, Iraq is certainly a very big part of discussion in politics, and you can't ignore that. But it seems to me that what you've got to have is some understanding of, from your viewpoint, what Iraq is all about. From our viewpoint, Iraq is all about security for this country, security in the international community.
But what do they do about immigration, because illegal immigration? Because the president is for this guest worker program, and I know a lot of the House members say it's amnesty.
Well, again, I mean, immigration is one of those issues that is an issue that has to be dealt with.
Yeah.
But if you take a look at what a Republican agenda would look like, such as growth and opportunity and competition and security, all of those things fit around the issue of immigration. And so what you do is you look at the bill that's being brought to you on immigration and figure out, does this apply to our security? Does this apply to a growth agenda to an opportunity agenda?
All right. Former Representative Bob Walker joining us from Cambridge, Maryland, right there on the banks of the mighty Chesapeake. Thanks, Bob.
Just ahead, see why there's a push to pass a national bill of rights for airline passengers. Yes, it will be for you.
And why some folks are telling California to butt out when it comes to telling parents how to discipline them their kids. Should you be able to spank? If you do, you might get fined $1,000.
At T. Rowe Price, successful investing is about balancing risk and reward intelligently. For each 1, 5, and 10-year period, 70% of our mutual funds beat their Lipper average, finding the right opportunity. Low-cost mutual funds from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a complete prospectus or profile with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
You own your own business, and today, you're expecting a package. The thing is, you're going to be at every address in town, except your own.
Don't you worry about a thing.
All you need is a mailbox at the UPS store. We'll sign for your packages, receive your mail, and keep it secure until you can pick it up, and your business gets a real street address. So when it comes to your mail, let the UPS store worry about it. That's our thing.
Don't you worry about a thing.
The UPS store, the place for mailbox services and a whole lot more.
Who's in the mood for a big weekend breakfast?
It's Tuesday, Dad.
I know.
No time. Gotta be at school early.
But the stuff's already chopped up. It's Jimmy Dean.
No trip, Dad. Sorry, gotta hustle.
But it's practically ready.
Wish I could. I have a status meeting.
Guys, I have to illuminate the entire Eastern Seaboard in 15 minutes. I think we have time.
The day begins with a happy breakfast. Try new bacon skillets made with real Jimmy Dean bacon.
Scott! I forgot to tell Marty to get DirecTV HD. Soon they'll have three times more HD capacity than cable. TV from outer space!
For the best in HD, get DirecTV.
Did you know 1 in 2 women will develop bone or breast health issues?
Really? I didn't know that.
One A Day Women's is the only complete multivitamin with more calcium for strong bones, and now more vitamin D, which emerging research suggests may support breast health. One A Day.
You're mine.
There's no contest when it comes to McDonald's tender, juicy chicken McNuggets. Right now, get a four-piece chicken McNuggets for just a buck. Yes.
Buying a new car should be one of the most exciting moments of your life. So when you buy a Pearson Mazda, we make sure your experience is fast, easy, and enjoyable. And then we back it all up with the Pearson name. So come in today and test drive the CX-7, acclaimed for its distinctive and sophisticated styling. Or the all-new MX-5 Miata, the best-selling two-seat convertible. And see why Pearson Mazda owners are some of the most thrilled drivers in Richmond. Pearson Mazda, a Pearson signature dealership. We invite you to join the family of satisfied Pearson customers.
Hey, a group of angry passengers pushing for a Bill of Rights after being stranded on a plane for 10 hours and a family tossed off a plane because their toddler misbehaving. Fox News legal analyst in perfect behavior again. Peter Johnson Jr. here to weigh in on these flight frustrations.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
All right, so this flight on December 29th, these passengers get stuck on the tarmac in Texas because there was a big storm. 10 hours. Yeah. Are you kidding me? Can you imagine what these toilets look like after that?
Well, they were overflowing. People were having panic attacks. People were getting sick. It was out of control. And so a lot of people are saying we need a passenger bill of rights to protect us when we fly. We don't want to become virtually kidnap victims,
right,
not in a criminal sense, but in a realistic sense, of an airline and spend 8 or 10 hours on a tarmac while you see other flights taking off.
Right.
There has to be a remedy.
So here are the Bill of Rights that these American Airlines passengers are pushing for this. Number one, returning passengers to terminals at gates after 3 hours on the tarmac or else. Number two, imposing penalties for losing baggage or bumping passengers and creating consumer committee to review and investigate complaints.
3 hours, I think that that's even too long.
Well, you know, the airlines say, well, you know, there's weather delays, there's mechanical delays that are unforeseeable, that unanticipated, unexpected. What can we do? Finally, in that Austin flight, the pilot said, I'm taking this plane off the runway. I'm pulling it to a hangar without authorization, without permission.
Really?
Because he was outraged by what was going on, that the fact that these people had to stay on this plane.
And we know about the luggage issues and creating, you know, consumers want to be able to spout off. There's usually someone there. Number four, requiring airlines to respond to complaints within 24 hours. That would be key.
It doesn't happen. The truth is that folks, in fact, and I know you're going to hate it, Gretchen, because I know you don't like a lot of excessive lawsuits, and neither do I, but people, in fact, have a remedy.
Yeah.
You know, there are limitations of liability on the ticket. They have excuses, they have ways out, but if you suffer as a result of the conduct of an airline, class actions have been brought, individual actions have been brought, but there has to be some deterrent to airline conduct.
I totally agree with that. At this point, there isn't.
And they figure people are going to walk it off and say, well, you know, what can I do? You know,
exactly, you're right.
And they forget about it 2 days later.
They have total control over it.
And then it happens again.
All right, speaking of suing, what about this toddler kicked off the plane, AirTran Airways? Do you think that that family will now sue AirTran? Or who has a leg to stand on in this argument?
Well, they might. They might sue AirTran. You know, a small child and the parents basically thrown off the plane because the child was crying. Now, I've traveled.
No, because the child wouldn't put on the seatbelt.
Well, that's what
there's
they say. That's what they say. That's what they say. And I think flight attendants have one of the hardest jobs in the nation. But flight attendants are not FBI agents.
Thank you.
And I get the feeling when I fly sometimes that they consider themselves to be deputized.
Oh, you're right. And I agree with you 100%. And thank goodness Steve is near us. We'd be totally overturned between you and Gretchen. Peter, last thing real quick. Does this Bill of Rights make it easier to sue?
If it goes through, it would.
Wow.
All but you wouldn't have to sue if it was put in place, because it would work. Yeah. Probably.
I like you. I like that idea.
Okay.
I like you, too.
We'll be right back.
It's the time of the season when love runs high in this time.
Moving your 401ks to Fidelity is groovy. Our retirement specialists make it so easy, they'll even do most of the paperwork. You dig? Call 1-800-FIDELITY. Smart move.
Around the globe, critics and audiences alike are applauding the power of Pan's Labyrinth. the best film of the year is being hailed as an outstanding work of art on the same altar of high fantasy as the Lord of the Rings trilogy. The phenomenon that has garnered 4 stars across the nation and appears on over 130 critics' top 10 list has now been nominated for filmmaking's highest achievement with 6 Academy Award nominations. Pan's Labyrinth, rated R, now playing.
Hometown.
Golf free for the rest of your life on all of our executive courses and enjoy free lifetime membership in all 8 of our country clubs, including the Arnold Palmer and Nancy Lopez signature courses. Enjoy the best active years of your life in the Villages. Log on to thevillages.com and order your free lifestyle video tour of the Villages today.
To a world of vibrant color, captivating design, and luxurious style with Stainmaster Carpet. Experience a whole new era in style and beauty for your home. Stainmaster Carpet, always stylish, always beautiful. For a retailer near you, visit stainmaster.com.
This is a great house.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
Today's weather is brought to you by Kohler. Inspired creations for the home. The bold look of Kohler.
Roto-Rooter wants to help you out with all your plumbing problems, including what you do while you're in the bathroom. In a new sweepstakes, the company Roto-Rooter is apparently offering what they call a pimped-out John, along with features. It has a flat-screen TV, an iPod with speakers, and a refrigerator with a keg tap.
All right. All men in America will never leave the toilet room. If we've come to this.
The toilet room.
Yeah, the toilet room. Let's call it the bathroom. Also, good news for those who want to know the answer to what happened to Ted Williams' body. As you remember, we were talking about James Brown still in his living room. His body, even though he died 3 weeks ago, he's having some legal problems.
Years ago.
They don't know what to do with him.
James Brown. Ted Williams years.
That's what we were talking about. And then we're talking about Lennon. We don't know what to do with Lennon. The Russians don't, even though they don't know whether to bury him or not. Also, Ted Williams, we didn't know what to do with him. It turns out John Henry, his son, says he wanted to be frozen. His daughter says bury him. John Henry died, but Ted Williams' head is being frozen. His body is buried.
All right.
So right now, his head's in a locker.
Thank you for that update.
They had separated the head and the body and frozen them independently for a while, but apparently very expensive. We're supposed to move on. In the state of New Jersey, because the squirrels have been eating stuff on the ground that may have been contaminated by a, and that not a live shot, contaminated by a Ford Motor. That's right. The grass is not green
here. Just in, he's alive.
Toxic stuff from a Ford plant from the 60s and the 70s in Mahwah, New Jersey, being cleaned up. Now the EPA is saying some of the squirrels might have gotten into that area, so people of New Jersey, do not eat the squirrel more than twice a week.
Oh,
once a
gosh.
Week, fine. Twice a week, fine. 3 times?
No.
Good luck.
But here's the funny thing.
They're toxic.
We've been getting emails all morning about people who say, hey, I eat squirrel over here, and I eat squirrel down south, and I eat squirrel in the Midwest. And the best thing is, what was the gravy? Squirrel head gravy?
Yep,
squirrel head gravy. And these are some recipes on the Field & Stream website. So if you have your squirrel and you're thinking to yourself, it doesn't taste as, it doesn't have that same bite, here it is. Maybe it's the spices. Barbecued squirrel.
I can't tell you how many people have emailed me talking to us about squirrel recipes. There's a guy who said that his grandma or his mother, when she was right until she died at age 94, would make squirrel spaghetti sauce.
Oh
my goodness.
Hey, now, Gretchen,
the secret's in the meatballs.
That's all. Exactly right. People are emailing, don't knock it till you try it.
That's absolutely true.
It tastes like chicken, I'm sure.
Well, that's what they say. They say it tastes like chicken. You know, you just have in your head the image. For instance, Chris Wallace is joining us right now from Washington, D.C. Chris, what is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten? And then it turns out you said, you know, that's not bad.
Because you go to every country.
Oh, boy, there's so many ways to go here. It would end my career as well as yours. But listen, squirrel is delicious, and you guys are a bunch of effete Northeasterners. I know Brian is a sissy, and he's never would eat squirrel. Squirrel is good.
Listen to me. Hey, I will not eat squirrel.
Wait a minute. He just called you a sissy.
And he just called
us. I was going to address him until you rudely interrupted me, Steve. Hey, Chris Wallace. Yeah. Congratulations on your show every Sunday, and I'm checking my local listings, and I see it. But, Chris, when it comes to eating rodents, I've backed out. However, my shampoo has grind up animal protein, which does contain squirrel. So I'll put the squirrel yes, it does. Animal
squirrel?
Protein, they'll grind up a squirrel to give your hair additional body.
Oh, that's crazy. Well, that explains
so
your
you
hair.
So you will not eat squirrel. I will take you out, and we will eat squirrel together, Brian.
All right, and I'll shampoo.
Have you ever, Chris, you ever had rattlesnake?
Yes, I have.
I have too.
I've had horse meat. I haven't had rattlesnake.
You've had horse meat. All right. What about buffalo? Bison.
No, but I'd like to eat buffalo. I hear it's pretty good.
Oh, that's what I've heard. I heard Ted Turner's invested in a whole bunch of buffalo.
You know what? It's going to be an exotic lunch with Chris Wallace. You can win it here and a calendar.
Yeah, let's have it at the... Never mind.
Do you remember that time, Chris, there was a time when they made me do a segment here where it was like an adventure segment? And they told me that it was something else that it wasn't.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to tell you what it was because you might not be able to eat lunch.
It was Fox News Sunday.
Yeah, no. Well, no, but what the food
was. Oh, that's not very nice.
No. But anyway, it's not that I'm not adventurous. It's that I would choose not to eat squirrel. But if you want to take me out to lunch, I'll try squirrel with you.
There used to be a restaurant here in Washington called Dominique's. I don't think it exists anymore. And they used to specialize in wild game and things like that. But I'm sure you remember it. But
absolutely. And they used to have the Bastille Day waiters race that I took part in a couple of years.
I heard you early this morning. Is it true that you met Reagan when you were here?
That's absolutely true.
I did too.
He was a pretty great guy, wasn't he?
He absolutely was.
Steve and I went there on the same day, actually.
We did not, but I did invite him over to my house for dinner. Mrs. Ducey was having...
Squirrel.
No, she wasn't. We were having squirrel helper. Hey, Chris, enough with the food. What's your entree for Sunday on Fox News Sunday?
A very nourishing show on Sunday. We're going to be talking, actually, I think it's going to be very interesting. Two of the more intriguing figures in American politics. On the one hand, Sam Brownback, social conservative, Republican senator, running for president, who has decided to go against the president's policy on Iraq and also has broken with his base on immigration because he's for comprehensive immigration. And then we're also going to be talking to Joe Lieberman, who is a Democrat. He says he's now an independent Democrat. And I thought it was fascinating during the State of the Union speech because when the Democrats would be sitting on their hands during the president's speech, he was the only one to get up and cheer along with the Republicans for part of the president's package. So a Republican who has broken with the president and a Democrat who's supporting him.
Well, you know, it's interesting.
On Fox News Sunday. And more on squirrel recipes.
Fantastic. Finally, a cooking segment on those chat shows. But the thing is, I think Joe Lieberman is embracing the I in his title. Wholeheartedly, although he's going to have trouble at the Christmas party for the Democrats.
One of the questions I want to ask him is who among the Democrats that are running for president he could vote for. I don't see how he could vote for any of them for president.
You know what? He could switch the balance. He could be the Jim Jeffords of 2007.
There you go.
All right. Chris, it sounds like you got a great show. Do you really have time to talk to us? Maybe you should go start preparing.
I got as much time as you guys do.
All right.
Okay,
fine.
We're out.
You want to talk some more?
No. Well, we would have
Listen, the thing that really intrigued me was not the squirrels, it was the toilet. Because I Gretchen was so right. If I had that toilet, I'm not coming out.
You mean because it's got the beer?
That seat would never go down.
Because it's got that beer tap, Chris?
No, well, and that part of it, but it didn't have like a TV set. And look at that thing.
So that could be
Why would you need to go to any other room of the house if you have that?
So that could be the Chris Wallace command post right there.
Absolutely.
What are you, LBJ?
That's like Star Trek. I mean, I could be Captain Kirk in that thing.
You know what? Talk to your set designer. I'm sure they could contact Roto-Rooter. You could get one of those free or at cost.
Look at Chris Wallace.
There you go.
Hey,
you're playing our song.
I like the fuzzy seat on the toilet. Did you see that?
Fuzzy seat?
Yeah, look at that.
Well, Chris, it was nice talking to you, and we love your standoff nature.
What did one of your guests bum out? You seem to have a lot of time to talk to me today.
No, actually, you're just kind of eating it up on your own.
Actually, okay. Well, if you'd like to do the headlines, I'm supposed to do the headlines
Can
now.
You see the prompter there, Chris?
We don't have prompter here. Yeah, I ad lib everything on my show.
Yeah. You know what? We type it all out, and we taped this last Thursday.
Yeah, this isn't live. This is so
I'm looking
old,
directly
show.
At my audience. I'm not just reading words that are going down, scrolling down a screen.
Can you see
you
the
guys
prompter?
Go ahead.
Can you see it?
You can't. All right, Chris, have a great weekend. We'll see you on Sunday. In the meantime, Gretchen Carlson, the one part of our program that is prepared.
Yeah, I was going to say.
The headlines, and we've got them now.
All right. Headlines here. Police have issued an Amber Alert after more than 200 searchers failed to find that missing three-year-old boy in Montana. The kid's father says he brought the boy out to the car Wednesday night, but when he returned from going inside to get another child, the boy had disappeared. Never leave your kids in the car. White House hopeful Tom Tancredo is calling for the end of the congressional black and Hispanic caucuses. The Colorado Republican says race-based groups of lawmakers amount to segregation. The father of the coach at the center of the South Carolina cheerleading scandal steps down from the school board. Jill Moore's dad says he wants to take care of his daughter and avoid any conflict of interest. Nicole Kidman was checked out and released from the hospital after a car crash during the shooting of her latest film. Kidman's stunt car was being towed through downtown L.A. by a camera rig when it skidded and crashed into a street pole. And those are your headlines. Yeah, but I think she's going to be okay. So it wasn't that big of a deal.
Hey, you know what, Gretchen? Here's some good news about the economy that you're just not going to be getting. And it's about the deficit. You know, the president put together a package, and a lot of people thought that was, you know, he was just shooting the moon when they came up with his economic plan. They said, this is my plan to cut the deficit. Not only has this administration, and here in 2006, now going into 7, cut the deficit, they're 3 years ahead of schedule. It was an all-time high,
terrific.
$417 million. It's now cut in half.
That's right. They say there could as well be a surplus by the year 2012. The big question is, and the Congressional Budget Office really was unable to factor in the cost of war. Right now they're taking into account the $75 billion that has been set aside, but the president's going to have to go back with the supplemental and ask for about another $100 billion. Beyond that, they don't know, but it does look as if the United States is headed for a surplus. Meanwhile, here's some other good news, and this is a Fox News Business Alert. The government is reporting that orders to U.S. factories for big ticket items, you know, airplanes and stuff like that, rose 3.1% in December. It's the largest amount in 3 months. It was led by a huge jump in demand for commercial aircraft and the biggest increase in orders for cars and trucks in more than 2 years. So obviously Americans feeling like things are going well. They're buying a bunch of big stuff.
You know, Time Magazine named us the people of the year, and boy, it's really changed my life.
The three of us?
Right, yes. I guess everybody in this room as well are experiencing our glory. But you know what? We deserve all the credit because it's the increase in tax revenue, despite the tax cuts, is the reason why the budget deficit is down. So America's working harder, making more, spending more. Together, we're on a treadmill.
Okay. You know what? Are you cold again in here?
I'm getting a little bit cold, but I'm willing to suck it up. You know why? Because David Letterman says when you're cold, you're more alert. You're a better audience. You're a better broadcaster. And he's the guy America used to look up to.
Baloney.
That's right.
I'm just wondering if you have some clout, if you could ask him to.
All right. I'll go.
Can you go?
I'll go.
Can you go check it out?
Yeah, I was never allowed as a child to check the thermostat.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to take advantage of my being a grown-up.
While you're doing that, I think Steve's going to do the weather.
Absolutely right, Gretchen. We thank you very much. I'm here in the Chris Wallace office. As you can see, Mr. Wallace has left his office and is now preparing for Fox News Sunday. Meanwhile, behind... What's that?
What does Gretchen want it on?
50.
It's on 66 right now.
Yeah.
Oh.
Of course, we're hearing the voice of Brian Kilmeade, who currently is behind the scenes, much like the Maury show, behind the flats, trying to find the thermostat.
He's still on?
Maury? Yeah.
Yeah.
Look
it's
at that.
20 outside. Can you see that? 16. It's 16 here.
What do you mean 20 out?
It feels like
it's 20 degrees outside. It's only 16 degrees in the studio.
So right. That's.
I think it's 71.
That's nutty.
Did you just turn it up?
No, I just turned it up. So it's just a matter of it clicking and hope it doesn't make any noise because we're on television.
Okay.
That's all.
Thank you.
All right, Brian Kilmeade. Thank you very much.
I did it.
Now, Brian, go out and get me some squirrel.
Fine. I'm going to just get in the car.
Some selected cities throughout the Northeast. Man, it's cold this morning. If you're just going out to start your car or you've already delivered the kids at school, you know that is the case. It's going to be in the 20s in the Northeast. Bitterly cold there. Actually, it's warmer in the Northern Plains today than in the Northeast. Look at that. Rapid City in South Dakota, 42. What's so funny?
Because you know what? We're gonna. If Ted Nugent is watching, doesn't he talk about how to
kill it and grill it?
To kill it and grill it.
That's exactly right.
So how to assassinate a squirrel and eat it?
I don't think they consider it assassinating. Final
suicide?
Stop. Final stop. Out west, a great day in Los Angeles, almost 70 degrees. Meanwhile, Salt Lake City, 35, and Seattle, 52. Nice day. All right, plus some music from Rocky and Bullwinkle. All right, speaking of Bullwinkle, let's go right back on over to...
what does that mean?
I think he called you Bullwinkle.
He called me a moose?
Yeah, it's
moose
better than
and squirrel.
All right,
moose
just ahead,
and squirrel.
They go together. An insurance company wants to test how smart patients are before approving potentially life-saving stomach surgery to fight obesity.
It's yeah, break out the stapler. Plus, we'll talk to someone who's talking to California lawmakers on banning spanking. You're watching Fox and Friends. Not everyone is against spanking, except that child. But why would that child ever act up? That child's doing their homework. They shouldn't be spanked. Where were sports? Did Wallace eat up the sports time?
Hey, what's up? Looks like you're in a hurry.
I'm a legal document. Very date-sensitive material.
Chill out. You should do a Sudoku.
Sudoku? Okay, I have to get to a legal proceeding.
Ooh, legal proceeding. Look at you.
Yes, and I can't be late.
Oh, pardonnez-moi. You know, I'm just a plant.
Hey, my ride's here. I gotta go.
Right.
The post office comes to you with free package pickup.
Yeah, I have important things to do too, you know, like create oxygen.
People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals are known for their outrageous campaigns. But official government records show that PETA itself has killed more than 6 animals every working day since 1998. PETA employees now face felony animal cruelty charges for killing puppies and kittens and throwing many of them in a dumpster. Now you know. PETA kills animals and is using your donations to do it. Find out more at PETAKillsAnimals.com.
So, Stu, tell me how the Tidy Cats litter works.
Well, it's revolutionary. Now it's formulated to absorb quickly and create crumple-free clumps, which means odors locked in so you can have numerous felines over and no one would ever know.
You are such a bad boy.
You know it.
So can I invite some friends?
Yes.
Multiple strengths for multiple cats.
Hey, that's my sister.
Give it 3:30. I got soccer.
Oh, look at that.
I got it.
Here, honey. Who wants one? Honey, would you like one? Last one here. And then I'm taking you to Zach's. Right? So we'll do that, and then we'll go to the mall, pick up I'll get that for you, little buddy. Here we go. There it is. Okay. Where's my bun? What can make me feel? Is that my honey bun? Did you teach him that?
Little Debbie, unwrap a smile.
Ask your healthcare provider about controlled release formula Ambien CR. Then call or visit AmbienCR.com for this limited time 7-day free trial offer. It's the only sleep aid with 2 layers to help treat both types of sleep problems. One dissolves quickly to help you fall asleep fast. The other dissolves slowly to help you stay asleep. Ambien CR is a treatment option you and your healthcare provider can consider along with lifestyle changes and can be taken for as long as your healthcare provider recommends. Until you know how Ambien CR will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Be sure you're able to devote 7 to 8 hours to sleep before being active again. Side effects may include next day drowsiness, dizziness, and headache. It's non-narcotic. However, like most sleep medicines, it has some risk of dependency. Don't take it with alcohol. Call or visit AmbienCR.com for this limited time offer of Ambien CR. Remember, CR.
All right, 14 minutes before the top of the hour. Imagine having to submit to an IQ test before your doctor would operate on you. One insurance company, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Tennessee, insists on testing your IQ before you go under the knife. Joining us right now are doctors Robert and Jennifer Ashton, both Fox News medical contributors. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So the whole controversy is before they will give people the gastric bypass thing where they stomach the stapling and whatnot.
Right.
You got to do an IQ test?
It's not a specific IQ test as far as we know. I mean, they haven't released the specifics of it. It's psychological testing. And the importance is to make sure that these individuals understand the procedure and are able to follow the lifelong regimen and the changes necessary. If they don't have the capacity and they do this surgery, they're going to be putting these people's lives at danger if they can't follow and don't have the ability for whatever reason, psychosocial or economic reasons, to follow the lifelong regimen and changes necessary.
So at first when you read this headline, hey, you got to take an IQ test before you can get your stomach stapled, people are like outraged about this. Could it be discrimination against obese people, etc.? Jennifer, you're saying this kind of testing goes on for all kinds of medical procedures.
Correct. And not only does it go on for major types of surgery, such as organ transplants, this has been very well studied and well reported for patients undergoing organ transplants. They need to be studied and evaluated beforehand, because if they do not have either the intellectual capacity or the social or psychological capacity to understand the surgery and to be able to comply with what they're going to need to do after the surgery, they can really be in danger. So I think with this case, people kind of misunderstood where the insurance company was coming from. It really was not discriminating against obese people. It was taking a population that is growing in terms of numbers and studying them to better help those patients.
Sure. Well, here's the thing. You know, there are a lot of really smart people and really social people who have that done and then don't follow the diet. So it doesn't seem like it would really matter whether or not you were underwent a battery of psychological and intelligence tests.
Well, it's true. It's not just intelligence. It's the ability overall. You're right. It's hard to come up with one test that does it. That's why they meet with their internist. They meet with a nutritionist. They meet with a psychologist. They meet with a surgeon. They have a multidisciplinary team. Right. And they all evaluate these patients and they all come to an agreement, just like you would do in organ transplantation or being on a national trial for chemotherapy. Teams work together in order to assess the ability of the individual that will participate in that surgery or procedure.
And you know what I think this underscores also, which I think is going to become more and more important as our healthcare climate changes, is the patient's responsibility has to be hand in hand with the medical team, as Rob was saying. So it's unbelievable how many patients do not understand what diagnosis they have, what surgery they're undergoing, what medications. And this really brings that to the forefront. Patients need to know.
And life-altering changes in their lives post surgery that they have to abide to.
All right. Absolutely.
The Ashtons, we thank you very much for making
a
studio call today.
Thanks.
All right, 11 minutes before the top of the hour, straight ahead, some California lawmakers want to ban spanking. You spank somebody, fined $1,000. Well, one mother we're going to talk to says spanking works and is an important tool for parents, and she's willing to cough up the $1,000 right now. Her story, straight ahead. Fox and Friends.
What we do.
You're looking at the unit body structure of one of the most well-built sedans in America. Its reputation for quality and reliability are unmatched. Its commitment to safety, uncompromising. This is the soul of every Accord we make. Then we pour our hearts into it. And that completes the picture. The Accord from Honda.
Lease a Honda Accord for $199 a month for well-qualified customers.
Campbell's Chicken Noodle Possibilities. Slurp noodles, broth, slurp some more. Mmm, good, that's for sure. Slurping's fun in every way. Wholesome Campbell's makes their day. Possibilities.
If you have a cold and high blood pressure, you should know that decongestants in these cold medicines can raise your blood pressure. So why take them? Take decongestant-free Corsedin HBP. Powerful cold relief that won't raise your blood pressure.
Stay calm. We're going to save you. Stop freaking out. Hop into the basket one at a time.
Save some cabbage. Sign up for Comcast Digital Voice for just $39.95 a month, every month. With unlimited local and long distance plus voicemail. Because the less money you pay, the more you get to keep for yourself. Just call 1-888-COMCAST. Comcast Digital Voice. It's Comcastic.
One call does it all. Joins body and paint.
Collision repair, mechanical, to let the pros who know take care of you. A state-of-the-art facility, and all our work is guaranteed. Our staff is constantly certified, so we can
call does it all. Dorn's Body and Paint.
Out of Bounds. Out of Bounds on Ice with an NHL All-Star wrap-up and much more.
There is worse than the Bruins, and frankly, it has been the Flyers this year.
Out of Bounds, tonight at 7 on CNH, the Comcast Network.
Nancy Kerrigan presents a weekly series of skating's top stars and up-and-coming hopefuls. Nancy Kerrigan's World of Skating. Sundays at 7, exclusively on CNH.
Presented by Toprosin. Heal the damage that causes the pain.
It's exciting. It's entertaining. It's a premier company in the cable industry with unique products and services and a wealth of career opportunities. Be empowered to reach your potential with us and see why cable television is an unbeatable opportunity. Brighten up your career with Comcast Spotlight and cable television advertising.
Interested in sales? Find out how you can become a valuable member of Comcast's advertising sales team. For more information on account executives and other available positions, visit us online at www.careers.comcast.com.
Children are absolutely sitting ducks for the superior size, speed, and force of an adult who's physically punishing them.
That was California Assemblywoman Sally Lieber, who next week is set to propose a bill that says spanking children under age 4 should be against the law. Our next guest disagrees. She says she spanked her child and it should not be in the hands of the government. Joining us from Palo Alto, California is San Jose Mercury News columnist Patty Fisher. Good to see you, Patty.
Good morning.
You know, I was just discussing a little bit earlier, I have two small children, 1 and 3. I'm in that evaluation period of whether or not I should spank or not. And yesterday my daughter acted up and I had that societal thing come down on me because we were in public. I'm absolutely not going to spank her in public. I feel like we feel pressured now, if we even consider spanking, that we're going to be somehow looked at badly in society.
Well, I don't think that spanking is necessarily the best way to discipline your kids, and I'm not an advocate of spanking. But I think that occasionally, almost all parents resort to one swift whack on the bottom,
right.
You know? And I don't think that's going to necessarily damage your kids for life, and I don't think it should be a reason to go to jail or pay a fine.
Right, and Patty, in fact, you had a column that I read in the San Jose Mercury last week. I confess, I spanked my child, let me pay my $1,000 fine and do my time. This proposed law is nuts. There are already laws on the books where it is against the law to abuse a child.
Absolutely. Well, California law does exempt from child abuse, from the child abuse statute, spanking a child on the butt by a parent. That is not considered child abuse. And so,
as long as it doesn't leave a mark.
Feeling is, as long as it doesn't leave a mark. I mean, obviously, if you wail on a kid and leave marks or badly spank a child, to the point where someone would notice it and report it, then that's going to be considered child abuse.
But isn't this a generational thing, Patty? Because it seems like in our generation, we were spanked, and now it just seems to me like spanking is out.
Well, I think that the studies show that spanking is not effective, and it can lead kids to become violent adults, I guess.
Like the video games on TV and all that?
Well, that's the thing. I mean, the problem with the studies is the ones that I've seen don't really differentiate between one spank and ritualistic spanking, you know,
right.
Where you take a kid over your knee, which I would never recommend to anybody.
Now, Patty, real quick, tell me what the ramifications have been for you since you came out and said, okay, I'm going to spank my kid, fine me, jail me.
Well, of course, I'm hearing from lots of people who say, absolutely, you know, I thank you for being realistic and rational about this. And most my mail has been overwhelmingly supportive.
Well, because it's a law that's absolutely nuts. Patty Fisher, columnist for the San Jose Mercury News. Okay, I've editorialized. Fine me $1,000. Patty, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
All right, we're going to wrap things up for the week. Coming up in about 2 minutes, sit down, put down your squirrel recipes, please.
We're getting a lot of them.
Tons.
I've always wanted a farm, like my grandparents used to have, with a stable, you know, for the horses. A place where everyone can get together, kids, grandkids, all my cousins, the whole family, and then pass it on to all the generations that come after me.
You once made a promise to yourself about your future. At John Hancock, we have the products you need to help build, protect, and sustain the future you've always wanted. John Hancock, the future is yours.
Here's how it works. Get the nation's slimmest smartphone for only $99.99. The Cube. With easy access to email and Windows Mobile, it's the stylish way to work. From Verizon Wireless, America's most reliable wireless broadband network. Verizon Wireless, it's the network.
Golf free for the rest of your life on all of our executive courses and enjoy free lifetime membership in all eight of our country clubs, including the Arnold Palmer and Nancy Lopez signature courses. Enjoy the best active years of your life in the Villages. Log on to thevillages.com and order your free lifestyle video tour of the Villages today.
At Joseph A. Bank, take an extra 25% off every clearance price in the store. Wool suits, only $148.50. Dress shirts, sports shirts, and sweaters, $29.99. Plus, an extra bonus, sport coats, $94. That's $395 sport coats, already clearance priced at $188, an incredible $94. Friday through Monday, only at Joseph A. Bank.
In the human body, the heart pumps blood through thousands of miles of arteries every minute.
Inventor of the Jarvik artificial heart, Dr. Robert Jarvik.
But high cholesterol can clog arteries and lead to heart disease or a stroke. Adding Lipitor is proven to lower bad cholesterol an impressive 39 to 60% when diet and exercise are not enough. And today, clinical evidence proves that Lipitor can reduce both your risk of heart attack and your risk of stroke if you have several common risk factors for heart disease. All important reasons to ask your doctor about Lipitor. Lipitor is not for everyone, including people with liver problems and women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. You need simple blood tests to check for liver problems. Tell your doctor if you're taking other medications or if you have any muscle pain or weakness. They may be a sign of a rare but serious side effect. Lipitor is one of many treatment options to consider with your doctor. Could you be doing more with Lipitor? Ask your doctor.
It said we have to say goodbye, but Steve, you're going home to a place where
I live,
where you live, where the squirrels glow.
That's right, exactly right. Where the toxic squirrels are. Don't, folks, only eat two per week, according to the EPA. Thanks for joining us this week. We'll see you on Monday. Here's John Scott.
Thank you, Steve, and good morning. I'm John Scott. This is Fox News Live.